I got this from your...
If you ever step foot into my dressing room again, I will rip you apart just like I've done to Sherry. Thin face, no one. If brains were black powder, you couldn't blow your nose as I have said before. I will say again, using mere words to describe me is like using a screwdriver to cut roast beef. I am your unforeseen contingency. I am the vandal on your mind, on your heart, your body, and your soul. And when you die, step foot into the square circle, one-on-one, I, Louis Vachon, will leave you lying like the pig you are and prove who the queen of the ring really is.
Welcome to WWF Superstars!
Ladies and gentlemen, he is accompanied by Paul Bearer. Let's welcome The Undertaker!
Perhaps the most awesome force in the World Wrestling Federation today. The man in black.
See the way he's carrying that urn? That reminds me of the way The Undertaker was carried out of WrestleMania.
You gotta bury your grill.
All right, Mr. Bearer, it has been proven time and time again, The Undertaker is literally unstoppable.
Oh, yes. Not only is my Undertaker unstoppable, he is the most powerful entity in the World Wrestling Federation. In fact, he is the most powerful entity that walks the face of the earth. And Giant Gonzalez, unfortunately, he's headed directly for you.
Giant Gonzalez, I've grown tired of your futile attempts at trying to destroy what cannot be destroyed. Not only will I draw power from the souls of the deceased, I will draw power from the souls of the living. Gonzalez, I've met you in your element. Now you must meet me in mine. Gonzalez, you must enter the world of the dark side. The dark side where only the Undertaker survives. The dark side where you, Gonzalez, will be made to suffer. Gonzalez, rest in peace.
For the matchup, Paul Bearer leading The Undertaker into a head-on collision with the 8-foot giant Gonzalez.
I'm Bart, and this here's Billy. You know, ever since we signed with the WWF, all we've been hearing about is trouble. Trouble from the likes of the Head Shrinkers, Money Incorporated, and the Beverly Brothers.
And you know, there's nothing like a little scrap to get a man's attention. So me and Bart figure that we're gonna go to the WWF and look for a little tag team excitement.
And when the smoke clears,
they'll go down.
I think Doink is going to end up with double vision.
And again, perfect. Working on the left leg. He softened it up earlier on. He's going to stay right with it. Why not?
Now look.
Yeah, now look.
Why not be a gentleman?
Be
Doink
a gentleman.
Says, wait a minute. Why not back up and wait a minute?
As long as we don't see more than one Doink, Mr. Perfect has a tremendous opportunity here to qualify to be in the King of the Ring tournament,
which is equally as prestigious as the WWF Championship belt.
Well, I'll tell you, speaking of the title, the Hulkster against Yokozuna. It won't get any better than that in the WWF. What a matchup at the King of the Ring event.
It's the first correct decision that Jack Tunney has made, ordering a rematch.
I see.
That's right. Because Hulk Hogan should not even, for him to even be carrying the World Championship belt around, it's a crime is what it is.
Oh, I see, a crime.
Not as bad as you carrying the crown around.
Oh. Well, you know what could happen.
I'm not saying this is going to happen. Tunney's made some controversial decisions as of late, no doubt of that. But what if he ordered the King, Jerry Lawler, to enter the King of the Ring tournament?
Oh, wow, what a knee lift! Going to the outside, we'll be right back. We're back with our WWF action, and Mr. Perfect just rammed into the ring post, and Doink beats the count back in. Nip and tuck matchup all the way.
Doink, oh, wait a minute, going up to the top.
Going up to the top rope and Doink down across the back of the head. Standing by now, ladies and gentlemen, the Hawaiian Crush. And Crush, there's no doubt that you're looking forward to...
Wait a minute. Doink, how can you be here and there at the same time?
It's an illusion.
What is going on here? Wait just a minute.
He just told you. What do you mean what's going on? It's an illusion. This guy's the master of illusions.
I thought Crush was scheduled to join us.
There's more to it than that.
I bet that's trickery here.
I can see it now.
What?
Headlining in Las Vegas. Siegfried, Roy, and Doink. Masters of illusion, yes.
Siegfried, Roy, and Doink.
Oh, got a ring to it.
Perfect, firing off into the chest area with a forearm. Oh, look at this. And right back with a forearm in his own right, Doink the Clown. Who will be King of the Ring? It could very well be either Doink or Mr. Perfect. Snap suplex. Taking nothing away from Doink's wrestling ability. He looks like a fool. He looks like a clown. But he is a consummate wrestler and an evil, evil man. I see nothing to laugh about thus far in this matchup.
He's not taking advantage of Mr. Perfect being hurt. He's just, he's into himself.
He's having a good time in there right now.
Well, he is. He might not be having a good time for long.
What if the King had to face Doink the Clown for the King of the Ring qualifying matchup? Who knows? On the top rope again, Doink! And again, right into the head of Mr. Perfect.
This guy's a riot.
Yeah. I've never seen such confusion among commentators. All throughout this match, I've told you, he's not Mr. Perfect, he's Mr. Pretty Good, and I've also told you that I am the one and only King of the Ring. Can't you get that straight?
Perfect now being set up by Doink. A whip to the ropes coming off. Doink missing with the left hand. Oh, connecting with the right. Perfect. Nice uppercut. Perfect hammering away. A slugfest developing here. Back and forth. Perfect wraps up. Doink's ball back in. 2 and 3. Gets him.
No, he didn't. No way.
It was close. Very close. And again. Perfect wrapping up Doink and trying to get him over. Trying to slide him right down the back. Perfect trying to prevail. Yes.
Got him.
1, 2, 3. No. Count of 2. What a seesaw matchup.
Well, I guess it's obvious now. He's no longer perfect. He's mediocre at best.
To the rope. Doink hanging on. McCann hanging on. 2 and 3. Gets him that time for sure.
No, will the referee say 2?
Oh, come on. He got him. I saw it.
There's a lot at stake here, man. Let me tell you, King of the Ring. Come on.
Suplex. Perfect wants us when he wants it badly. And no, not much of a cover there. Perfect whip Doink. Perfect trying to set him up again. Wow. Look at this. And a reversal. Off the rope. Back body drop now. Perfect putting it. Here comes a perfect flex right there.
Count him out.
The bell. Well, who rang the bell?
Come on. What is this?
There's no time. What's the time limit on this?
Don't tell me. The time expired.
What was the time limit? I wasn't aware.
Oh, yeah, Tatanka, the big bad warrior. He likes to sneak up behind people and chop them in the head. That was a real good laugh, huh? Well, I had the last laugh, pal, because I not only got you, I not only got you, Indian, but I scalped you.
Bam Bam Bigelow, there are many things
sacred to my people, like the eagle feather. But to me, which is most sacred, is the red hair, the red streak that symbolizes all my Native Americans and all my people. And when you attacked me from behind, and I awoke, and I realized how you had desecrated my heritage, you started a fire in me that will burn until I get my revenge!
Well, here it comes, ladies and gentlemen. A man who, no doubt, will face sooner or later the only individual that has, in fact, been seated justifiably without having to qualify. He has been seated the number one seed in the King of the Ring tournament, making reference to former WWF champion and unquestionably the people's champion as we speak, the Hitman Bret Hart.
You mean the narcissist is not already seated?
Well, the narcissist must defeat Bob Backlund this weekend if, in fact, he is going to be entered into the King of the Ring tournament.
Oh, but the Hitman gets a free ride in there, right?
He's the only one who deserves justifiably a free ride.
Why is that? Why does he deserve it?
Possibly it might be the reason is because he got robbed of the WWF title by Yokozuna.
He's the only man I know in the WWF. They got flattened twice in one day. First by the narcissist, and then by Yokozuna, and then he gets a free ride in the tournament.
It's not exactly a free ride. If you paid dues like the Hitman Bret Hart has paid, you deserve an opportunity to be seated at number one. Luger must qualify. You, Jerry Lawler, must qualify. We tried to get earlier on a winner between Perfect and Doink. They, too, are still in the running, but neither individual has qualified to date. And look at this man, if you would. The narcissist Lex Luger is truly in love with himself.
And everybody's looking at him. Look at that. Every eye in the place is on the narcissist.
Crush took a real good look at him on Monday Night Raw last Monday.
Yes, he did. And speaking of Monday Night Raw, this Monday night, one-on-one, Hacksaw Jim Duggan could become the Intercontinental Champion should he defeat Shawn Michaels. What a matchup this Monday night.
Ooh.
Yeah. Come on. Was this peekaboo time? I mean, it's like he's just giving us a little glimpse of his extraordinary physique.
Oh, look at this young lady. You want her fainting? You want people falling down the aisles?
Her thumbs are down.
Yeah, right.
Yes, they are.
Look at the girls. Look at them swooning right now. They'll be passing out left and right.
The narcissist Lex Luger, more concerned with his appearance, I believe, than anything else in this world.
Well, he knows he doesn't have to be concerned with his opponent. He knows what's going to happen to him.
Oh, really?
Going to knock him out like a light.
Uh-huh. What's going to happen when he faces the Hitman Bret Hart? That has a superior physique. There's no question about that. But after all, this is not bodybuilding. This is the World Wrestling Federation. A look of admiration. All right.
Wow.
But what can you do in the squared circle? What will the narcissist Lex Luger do against the Hitman Bret Hart? Wait a minute, look at this. This young man taking a look at himself. Oh, no!
Nice little forearm there, wasn't it?
Knocked him out, no doubt.
I think you're right. There is no match. There's absolutely no match here whatsoever.
One split second in the spotlight is all he had.
I think Jack Tunney made a bad decision, folks, allowing the narcissist Lex Luger to compete with all the rest of the superstars in the WWF. Luger has an unfair advantage. He has that metal plate in his forearm.
So what do you think? You think he should be deprived of the opportunity to make a living?
I'm not saying that. I think perhaps a protective gear or what have you should be ordered by Tunney. I mean, after all, something has to protect the opponents of the narcissist Lex Luger. It's only fair.
All they have to do is protect themselves. You know how? No. Don't sign a contract to wrestle the narcissist.
I see.
Don't put your name on the dotted line.
The narcissist Lex Luger enjoying himself as we take you now to the event center.
Yo, Santana, óyeme, chico. Next week, right here, Razor and El Matador. The winner, he goes on in the King of the Ring tournament. You such a tough guy, Chico. Don't sing it. Bring it.
Razor Ramon, next week, you and I, the winner of this match qualifies for the King of the Ring first round tournament coming up. And I guarantee you one thing, Razor Ramon, when the bell sounds, this Mexican is going to be coming at you, and I intend to put it to you. Olé!
Making his way down the aisle from the way he runs back this Bam Bam Bigelow, that attack. You 30 enjoyed that?
Let me put it this way.
Missed
it. It was a very
huge
hair-raising experience for Tatanka.
Well, I'll tell you something. That Native American is still undefeated here in the WWF. And Bam Bam Bigelow may have a big price to pay for what he did to Tatanka last week on Superstars. Now, this man right here is one of the most highly recruited athletes in the WWF right now.
Tell me,
now.
What do you know about him?
Hey, this guy was a high school All-American in football in Kansas City. He was a four-year starter at defensive tackle for Kansas State University in the Big Eight Conference. He is a magnificent athlete and a guy that a lot of managers right now in the WWF would love to sign.
That's what I hear. That's the rumbling I get. I hear that, all the managers are looking into this man. They all like to have a piece of him. They can see money in this guy.
Oh, yeah. He's got great agility, 360 pounds or so, and he is one nasty customer.
He looks nasty.
Ooh. Oh. You can hear the impact of that clothesline. Mr. Hughes, 6'5", 360, and very, very... sadistic, shall we say. Look at the strength of this man. Slamming Mark Ming very easily. As we said, virtually every manager here in the WWF has their eye on this man.
He can make somebody a lot of money.
No doubt about it. Oh, they kicked him right in the face.
I mean, to get your foot up that high.
Well, I understand that Reverend Slick has even inquired about this man. And he's made some comments. As a matter of fact, Brain, let's listen to Reverend Slick's comments now.
Slick and ruin him.
You know, Mr. Hughes, I've always prided myself in my ability to recognize raw talent. And you know, there's so much about you, your self-confidence, your self-esteem, but it's just headed in the wrong direction. You need to hook up with the Reverend. I can help you channel those energies into a positive light.
Sure that he could. That might not be a bad situation. It is a bad situation for Mark Ming as he was destroyed with
here
that side
is your
slam.
Winner, Mr.
Hughes. Mr. Hughes, very, very impressive here. And right now, ladies and gentlemen, let's go to the event center.
He is mean.
I want to thank Jack Tunney for putting me as the number one seed in the King of the Ring tournament. You know, I can't worry about title matches or anything else right now because the only thing I can do is go straight to the top. And the best way to do that is to be the King of the Ring. You know something? Being the number one seed is perfect for me because I'm going to prove to everybody that I am the best there is, the best there was, and the best there ever will be.
Champion Hulk Hogan, look at my man, Yokozuna, 505 pounds. He's prepared. He's ready for you. Are you ready for my Yokozuna? Huh? Are you? Let me tell you, this time around, come for the King in the Ring in Dayton, Ohio, come June 13th, boy song. He'll be the winner. And also, he'll win the WWF Heavyweight Championship. And all the little Huskers be sad. Very, very sad. And Yokozuna and Mr. Fuji very happy.
So
because, Boyson, we're going to make sure you be out of circulation.
Sayonara.
Five-time World Wrestling Federation champion Hulk Hogan is holding court here on the sands of the beautiful Gulf beaches of Clearwater, Florida. He is on the movie set. Gentlemen, that's the business of the hour. However, there is future business that is going to be conducted as part of the King of the Ring, June 13th in Dayton, Ohio. I don't have to tell you, I am talking Yokozuna and the World Wrestling Federation.
Well, what I can tell you right now, little dude, is you're talking trash, brother. Because the only reason I'm out here on the movie set, the only reason I'm in Hollywood is simply because it was a prior commitment. Is that straight between you and me?
You've got it.
You darn right I got it, brother. I got the World Wrestling Federation title for the fifth time. And I'm going to hang on to it, brother. All I got to say is in Dayton, Ohio, when the strongest power in the world, Hulkamania, runs wild, the ring crew from the WWF better reinforce the ring. Because when I get old, Fatso, up in the air, when I get old, Yokozuno, Stinko Buno, in the launch position, I'm going to press him over my head. I'm going to show him off to all my Hulkamaniacs in the arena. And then, when he splits the ring in half, don't panic in L.A., New York, Kansas City, or Tokyo. It's not a worldwide earthquake. It's just Yokozuno going down for the second time. Now to cut to the quick, brother. We're going to take care of that dude in Dayton. But you, Fuji, Yokozuno, or anybody else that messes with me, my little holsters, or the brothers at my side, you're messing with my family. I precious that. I regard that more than life. I'm so excited.
Yay,
I can't even talk.
I can tell it.
But the thing is, in Dayton, Ohio, brother, you got a date with disaster. Brutus the Barber's going to be hanging in back. And after I beat Yokozuna for the 1-2-3, you're going to get a little haircut. You're going to look just like Mr. Fuji. What you going to do?
Welcome back, everyone, to WWF Wrestling Challenge. Jim Ross and Bobby the Brain Heenan back with you. And what a main event it will be at the King of the Ring competition on June 13th. Hulk Hogan and Yokozuna one-on-one for the WWF title, Brain.
Well, this time Yokozuna can prepare himself. This time he's got himself a couple of months to really get ready. And I'm talking about get ready for the five-time WWF champion Hulk Hogan. Hulkamania is going to be finished.
Plus,
King of the Ring.
Plus, we have learned that Bret Hart has been seated number one in the King of the Ring tournament. And I think that is one of the better decisions that Jack Tunney has made in the last few weeks.
Well, you don't understand. You're new here. Being number one seed means that you have greased the palm of Jack Tunney. That means he bought his way into it.
I don't believe that whatsoever.
Eat your heart out, Tuts.
Well, we are going to see this qualifying matchup for the King of the Ring competition. The winner of this competition will join Bret Hart in the tournament. If we can ever get the mirror out of the ring and
join him,
Lou gets to admire himself. This guy really is
and
full of himself.
His opponent.
And here's one of the most down-to-earth, one of the nicest guys who ever competed in the WWE.
At 234 pounds from Mayberry, O.B. Taylor.
It's Bob Backlund, and he's from North Dakota State University, Bobby the Brain.
Wow.
And he was also, you can say wow for the fact that he was, for about 6 years, the WWF champion.
North Dakota State? What do you have to do there to graduate? You want to milk a cow with your left hand?
A fine institution, and they have a great wrestling program.
Oh, they certainly do. Tomorrow, Elmer, maybe you can drive the truck, and I'll talk to the pig.
Hey, everybody can't be born with a silver spoon in their mouth and have a chauffeur named Jennifer, who told me, by the way, that she hasn't had a raise in several months.
She said that?
Yes.
She's fired. I'm going to load her just like I found her. You need a job on the weekends?
I'm a little bit busy on the weekends.
Oh, that's right. You just drive pickup trucks.
Back to put go behind, and he cradles Luger. Near fall situation. Back and hooks the arms. He's right behind Luger, and Luger able to kick out at two. Luger now trying to a slam inside cradle by Backlund. Backlund is taking the big man off his feet. Another arm drag takeover. Single leg. Backlund has Luger confused, and the big man off his feet. Backlund up and over. Pinning predicament. Gonna get him here. One, two. Oh, that was close. Luger's got to get outside to regroup, and the narcissist is not.
Pin him about four or five times. He's taking it right to Lex Luger. He's not laying back. That's good strategy right there. But I don't think it's going to work. You know, he's 43 years old, Bob Backlund. He's been out of the WWF for about 7 or 8 years. He did hold that title for 6-7 years. That takes a lot out of you. But he's in tremendous shape for his age. But you can't compare him to Lex Luger. It's like comparing horse manure to ice cream.
Well, Luger at 6'5", 275, has a definite strength and obviously size advantage over Bob Backlund, but he's also got something that you can measure, and that's that steel plate that is in his right forearm that has knocked everyone absolutely unconscious that he has faced.
Boy, he's had more hits than Elvis.
Luger back in the ring now. Well, he needs to control the tempo here because Backlund started off very, very quickly. And Backlund does have a quickness advantage. Backlund has him in the ropes. Well, good sportsmanship by Backlund, but he paid for it, perhaps. What? Got the elbow right in the face.
Well, you want good sportsmanship, you go to North Nebraska State, wherever he's from.
North Dakota State.
Same thing, same neck of the woods.
Well, Lex Luger, I talked with him earlier today, and after he got through talking about himself for about a half an hour, he did get around to talking about Bret the Hitman Hart, and that's going to be a tremendous matchup, Hart and Luger one-on-one.
Oh, And Bret Hart, in the back of his mind, he's not forgetting how he was knocked out cold at the WrestleMania breakfast brunch. And that has something to do with him losing that title, too. You know, he rattled his cage pretty good.
You're exactly right about that. It was a cheap shot. Luger caught him from behind, caught him blindsided him.
Doesn't matter what you call it, as long as you get the shot in.
Luger, Irish whip. Now it's going to be reversed by Backlund. Him up. Bobby Backlund showing his strength.
Oh, he's powerful.
Drop kick caught Luger in the face. Backlund now showing some offensive spark. Has Luger up. A Tommy drop. He'll compress the vertebra there. Luger in trouble.
He's going right in for the pin. He wants it.
Got him rolled up. Oh, Luger's great leg strength. Backlund was going to roll back with him, and that vintage move of his, but Luger's leg strength was too much for Backlund to overcome.
The Heenan cradle.
The Heenan cradle.
Stole that from me,
I
too.
I've never heard that term used in my career.
Yeah, but you went to
Heenan.
South Dakota State.
No, I didn't.
Oh, that's right. You're a jokey from Muskogee, wherever they call you.
Backlund pulling his way back up on the apron, and oh, he caught him right there. He caught him with that forearm, and Backlund knocked all the way down the aisle, and he is not moving. He's out of it.
I can't see from my vantage point here. Luger looks great.
He caught him with that controversial forearm, and the referee, Bill Alfonso, exercising his count, and Luger's going to win it by a count out, and he will advance in the King of the Ring tournament.
Well, where's Backlund?
The winner of this match.
Backlund is out cold.
Could it be that this man headed to the ring will be the next King of the Ring?
Weighing 243 pounds, Doink McMahon!
What about tongue-in-cheek?
His opponent, weighing 215 pounds, the Kamikaze Kid!
Doink the Cloud here on Monday Night Raw, squaring off against the Kamikaze Kid, making his debut. And who knows, maybe Doink the Clown, if he can qualify, just might be. Oh, look at this! And the King of the Ring tournament. Doink the Clown going to work on the Kamikaze Kid. Whoa, grabbing him to the buckle down to the canvas. Now, Bobby the Brain Heenan, you know full well that last week there was now one. You know darn well. Oh, look at that maneuver. There were two Doink the Clowns, and Crush was not having double vision.
Doink has a split personality.
Oh, please. It's an illusion, right?
It's an illusion. It's like David Copperfield does. Magic.
Certainly was no illusion that Doink did not qualify this past weekend with his matchup with Mr. Perfect. Then again, Mr. Perfect did not qualify either for the King of the Ring tournament. Both individuals wrestling to a draw. They may get another opportunity somewhere down the line. Doink going to work on the Kamikaze Kid, teaching him thus far a wrestling lesson.
Sadistic and evil, Doink the Clown, both of them, not double vision, two Doink the Clowns.
You know, he can spit at you with a rubber tongue, he can throw a pie in your face, he can do all those humorous things, but basically this guy is a wrestler, he is one.
Basically, this clown is evil.
Oh yeah, he's evil, but he's a great wrestler. Yes, he can walk away with the King of the Ring, the whole thing.
Yes, I believe you're right about that. Such are the wrestling skills of Doink. spaghetti. Very, very vicious this week. Doink the Clown. You wonder which one this was. Was it this the doink that was on the right side up in the balcony, or the one on the left watching last week's match?
McMahon. Yeah. It was the doink in the balcony.
Which doink in the balcony?
Which balcony?
By the way, Hacksaw Jim Duggan on the phone, apparently having a conversation with WWF President Jack Tunney. Hacksaw Jim Duggan was persuaded to leave the ring area, and I believe Tunney is going to make a decision very, very shortly. Hopefully, we're going to have Hacksaw Jim Duggan with us. Look at this! Doink the Clown!
Look at this!
Putting a submission hold on a Kamikaze Kid! And the Kid wastes no time in surrendering.
Bring that bell out of that hole right there.
Let him up.
Duggan can't be talking to Tunney.
Why?
Duggan would be calling collect, and Tunney's too cheap to accept the charges.
Hopefully have Hacksaw Jim Duggan back with us when we return with our Monday Night Raw. Would you please welcome once again, please, Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
7 days away from becoming the new Intercontinental Champion.
He wishes.
All he needed was the match, the Lumberjack match, and he's got it, so that's all that matters right there.
Well, he's had two opportunities. This will be his second.
Hacksaw Jim Duggan. I understand that your wish has come true, and your sit-down strike apparently has paid off.
Well, not very often does old Hacksaw Jim Duggan get an opportunity to talk to the president, but Sergeant Slaughter came out here and told me Jack Tunney was on the telephone. So I ran out there and I said, Mr. Tunney, it's not fair, it's not right. Shawn Michaels can run away from me. And you know what Mr. Tunney said to me? He said, Hacksaw, Shawn can run, but he can't hide, because next week, baby, you got him in a lumberjack match for the Intercontinental title. Tough guy.
Well, I'm sure Mr. Michaels is not too happy about this at all. In a lumberjack matchup, when all the superstars surround the squared circle, when someone is thrown out, obviously Mr. Michaels won't be able to run very far.
He seems to spend more time outside the ring than he does inside. I'm not going to take nothing away from him. He's sure pretty, and he sure wrestles well, but he can't fight a lick. And Shawn Michaels, when I get you in the ring, I'm taking that title away from you. One way or the other, tough guy.
Thumbs up all the way for Hacksaw Jim Duggan, but a lumberjack match, very, very dangerous, because you never know what happens. If you're on the outside for any reason, either being thrown out or whether or not you're chasing Shawn Michaels, one of your adversaries just might be there.
Well, no question about it. No telling who's going to be outside the ring. But it's like back in my old football days. You got to keep your head on a swivel. You got to look around. You can't trust nobody. But Hacksaw Jim Duggan's mind is on one thing. That's the Intercontinental title. Tough guy.
All right, best of luck to Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Your wish granted by President Jack Tunney. The lumberjack match ordered, and who knows, you could very well be taking another look at the new Intercontinental Champion. Go for it.
USA! USA! USA!
That'll baby Hacksaw right there in your corner. Don't go away, the head shrinkers. Kamala in a very special surprise.
The gentleman, at this time,
this must be it. Here comes a special surprise ball. The man Randy Savage was talking about.
Just been one of the legendary figures of the World Wrestling Federation. One of the premier managers.
Sit down, Bobby.
Listen, there he is.
A warm welcome for Captain Lou Albano.
Yeah, you bet. Captain Louis Albano here on Monday Night Raw.
We don't get along, you know, McMahon.
Yeah, no kidding.
That I like Captain Lou forever and ever and ever.
I mean, he's nuts. He's nuts. He's off the wall as anybody.
You're the head cashew.
No, I'm sitting next to the head cashew.
Captain Louis Albano, the manager of more tag team champions than any other individual in the history of the World Wrestling Federation. What a stellar. Hey, Cap, come on over.
Don't
invite him over here.
Total combined.
Why not?
Right next to the
92 pounds.
Let's see what he's going to have to say. Been a long time since we have been in the company of Captain Louis Albano.
Open stamped you with one of those rubber bands, even.
Their opponent.
Daniel, hide your watch. You don't know what
coming down the aisle.
Hey, Capper, how you doing?
sit down.
At a come on,
look, come on, join us, and look who's coming to town.
49 pounds.
Take a look at this, if you want. Captain Lewis out. Quicker. Oh, you never look better. Look at this. What kind of condition? You must be an Ica Pro.
Unbelievable, Vinny. I'm an Ica Pro. I walk 5-6 miles a day. I'm in the best condition of my life. I got the body that women love and men envy, brother. I feel good.
You used to manage the Wild Samoans off in Sika.
First of all, Vinny, I'd like to say it's an honor and a pleasure to be back with the major leagues of professional wrestling, the WWF. And sitting next to the main man, the macho man, a man that's often imitated but never duplicated. Vinny, it is an honor. Now, getting back to the Samoans, you know, I did manage them. They were three-time world champions, Vinny. We call them the headhunters now. They've taken a change, I believe, for the worst. I don't know what it is, but something has gone wrong.
Mr. Albano, you have not made reference to the gentleman sitting to your left, Bobby the Brain Heenan.
Well, there's really not too much to make reference to. I'm not a fan of Bobby the Brain Heenan. I do respect the man, realizing that he has great managerial talent. He's a great announcer. He's a great commentator. However, I do not respect the man and his tactics. I believe that the man has gone astray. The man is the brain of a dehydrated BB. Put it in a pigeon or a parakeet, it would go backwards.
I like
that. I do believe he has to be watched at all times. He needs psychiatric care. The man has troubles. The man has problems. I do want to keep an eye on the demented halfwit. I call him Bobby Heenan.
I don't care to answer that.
I guess you're
not. I'm not a demented halfwit where you put my brain into a pigeon, he flies upside down.
Mr. Heenan, get it straight. I think he said fly backwards.
I don't care what he says.
A man's ruining my program. I've got us. Look at this. What we have here is the Head Shrinkers cleaning house. And if they were managed by Captain Lewis Albano, I'm sure things would be different. Look at this. Double team effort off the rope. Whoa! Regardless of what Bobby the Brain Heenan has to say, Captain Lewis Albano, it is indeed an honor to have you back here in the World Wrestling Federation.
Well, I got to say, Vince, it's an honor for me. We're in the major leagues of professional wrestling right here, the greatest organization in the world, but I'm glad to be back, Vince. I'm glad to be sitting next to Macho Man and yourself. Forget about Bobby Heenan, the demented halfwit, but I'm glad to be back, brother.
I'm not a demented halfwit.
You got the brain of a dehydrated BB. Put in a pigeon, a parakeet, fly backwards, brother. Stay
I did it. Put him up.
Wait, just stop him.
Take it easy.
Save yourself the embarrassment, Heenan. He'll knock you out quickly.
Look at this body, Heenan. The body that women love and men envy. Maybe I'll run all over you.
Hey, if it wasn't for the shrapnel I have in my back here, it's not important.
What about that yellow streak down your back?
Check your brain out, baby.
By the way, Yokozuna.
A bit of conversing here.
Yokozuna, we've just been told Yokozuna is going to be one of the Lumberjacks next week, right here on Monday Night Raw, and that spells trouble for Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
Well, you know the hatred there between Hacksaw Jim Duggan and Yokozuna. Now Yokozuna's going to be outside the ring as a lumberjack, a Japanese lumberjack, a 505-pound Japanese lumberjack. I'd pay to see that.
Well, you may have to. What a matchup that's going to be on Monday Night Raw. We already know that Yokozuna is going to be one of the lumberjacks. You wonder who else is going to be circling the ring, making sure that Hacksaw Jim Duggan and Shawn Michaels keep the action on the inside.
I got an idea.
What?
Since Yokozuna's going to be a lumberjack and he's as big as he is, why don't he just be the only lumberjack? I think that's fair.
Roger.
Oh, no!
Can you smell his brain bubbling there, Macho Man? He's got an idea. Boy,
he smelled something burning. He was thinking.
What a devastating pile driver we saw just moments ago.
Unbelievable, Vince, unbelievable.
And there's Alpha, whom Captain Lewis Albano used to manage.
And there's Sika hanging around his neck.
That's not Sika, you halfwit. That's not Sika. That's a shrunken head from a Seattle man.
Captain, when you were managing
from where?
Alpha and Sika, did you ever get any communication with them?
Yes, brother. I was able to get down. I talked some more, and you know, I said, you know,
I'll tell you what happened, Savage. When he managed them, they used to be Polish.
No, they used to be victorious. They used to be champions. Albano conversing now with one of the head shrinkers. Mr. Albano, what did you say?
I said, please try to go by the rules. Stop this cruelty because it's unreal.
They're not listening.
Give the man a fair chance.
I guess they're not. Then again,
Who?
Are you listening?
To who?
To Captain Lewis Alberto.
I can't understand a word what he says.
Oh, my, double headbutt there. Well, Mr. Albano, have you been impressed? Wait a minute, here's the cover. We have, oh, come on. They could end this, I believe, anytime they would want to. Are you impressed thus far with the mental prowess of the Brain, Bobby Heenan?
Well, I'm not impressed with Bobby Brain's brain, I should say, or Bobby Heenan's brain. I'm not impressed at all, Vince. Yep. He does nothing for me.
What about the Macho Man?
Oh, well, Macho Man is a legend in his own time. He I am impressed with.
Very unimpressed with the Brain. Thank you.
Hey, there you go. Don't turn your back to me, everyone.
By the way, Captain, what's that dangling from your ear?
Well, it's an eclectic rubber band, Vince, from an eclectic tree in Borneo, and I've always had that for years. You know that.
Borneo.
Borneo, that's right.
You're talking to a guy that speaks Samoan. He's wearing rubber bands. He's got half a tree hanging out of his ear. For what reason?
Why don't you lay dead, Heenan, and shut up?
That's it. Put him up.
Give the other end a chance.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
What
other
excellent
end? Advice on the part of Captain Lewis Alberto. Oh, my!
What should I do with my other end? I can't understand what he's saying.
Well, why don't you leave?
It's my show. Oh, I don't leave.
Well, look at this!
Oh!
A devastating maneuver.
Wow.
Is that what they mean when they say keep your head down?
Look at this. Not going up. Over on the top.
Watch the height he gets.
5-2 from the top.
Whoa, viciousness.
300 pounds, unreal. Got to break a man's ribs. Am I right, Macho Man? You've got to maim a man for life.
A good luck at Sabu and Fatu, managed by Afa and Captain Lewis Alberto. We would like to thank you very much for joining us here on Monday Night.
They're tearing them apart. Look at it.
Well, I'd like to thank you, Vince, for having me here as your guest. It's a pleasure and it's an honor. And I want to tell you one thing: the Samoans actually scare me. I don't know what's happened.
Well, come back soon.
No, don't.
Shut up, Captain.
Hey, I'll meet you out back afterwards.
Well,
you want to meet me out
come
back?
Come on outside.
I'll meet
right
you
now.
Out back.
Yeah, well, go ahead.
Which
Let's
way's
go.
The door?
You ready?
Yeah, you
can find the doorway.
Well, speaking of the doorway, settle down, guys. Perhaps you all should take a course on home improvement courtesy of the Bushwhackers and Coliseum Home Video.
Smack 'em, whack 'em.
With me right now is the Intercontinental Champion, Shawn Michaels. And Shawn, I know what you've gone through. It's been an uphill battle your whole career to win this. Now, like stab you in the back, Jack Tunney Incorporated.
You know, can you believe this? Have you ever, in the history of the World Wrestling Federation, seen an Intercontinental Champion treated this way? I mean, Jack Tunney, I'm the World Wrestling Federation Intercontinental Champion. And now Hacksaw Jim Duggan somehow gets me into a lumberjack match. I mean, come on, he protests, he calls Jack Tunney at home. I don't even have his home phone number, and I'm the Intercontinental Champion.
You see, that's what I don't like. It's not fair. If he's got Tunney's home phone number, you got to put the title up next week right here on Monday Night Raw. I don't like the sound of this.
No, neither do I. I mean, who knows who he's got up his sleeve? Plus, not to mention all the people he's going to have around the ring, all his buddies. I mean, you know, don't get me wrong. I got a couple numbers of myself. I got a couple friends out there. But you know something? Hacksaw Jim Duggan, one way or another, this thing's staying with me.
Let me know one thing. I know you must have something up your sleeve. What do you have planned for Hacksaw Jim Duggan?
Well, Bob, I'm not going to tell you.
I can fix that.
Don't miss the first ever lumberjack matchup. You won't believe it next week on Monday Night Raw.
Stay home, Duggan.
I'm sure your mom is extremely proud of her macho baby.
Thank you very much.
Yeah,
well, he's got a face only her mother can love, so.
Hey, now let's be nice.
Why?
Well, it's time to be nice. Springtime. King of the Ring's coming around. People are still waiting for you to get up enough gumption to enter. Hello. Are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Yeah. Well, when you're supposed to be in the King of the Ring.
Oh, please.
That is, you have to qualify. This week, as we mentioned earlier on, to qualify, will it be El Matador? Will it be Razor Ramon? Already in the King of the Ring tournament, the Hitman, Bret Hart, plus last week, the Narcissist, Lex Luger, qualified.
Two things are for sure, that the tax laws will always change and that you people will always try and cheat.
I thought maybe he was talking about the way that the King wrestled.
Oh,
always cheating, but look out, here they come! Man, look at these shirts.
Here are Nog and Zeg,
it's time to be nasty side!
course not.
Oh, I've been invited.
It is disgusting. Roaches are running around begging for raid in their house. It's terrible.
Roaches begging for raid.
And their tag team partner.
What a tag team partner the Nasty Boys have chosen this week. Kamala is a tag team member.
I'll tell you why.
Why?
They're stupid, that's why.
Oh, please.
They are.
Well, then again, Mr. Hughes, somewhat untested, although he's undefeated thus far. A lot of managers wanting to, by the way, one of them, I understand, is the Doctor of Style, the Slickster himself, is trying to negotiate some sort of a deal with Mr. Hughes. Every manager in the WWF apparently sees something in Mr. Hughes.
Man, now wait a minute. Could you imagine what a team that would make? Mr. Hughes and the mighty Kamala managed by Slick.
Ooh. Quite a tag team. But right now it's six-man tag team action. And a handshake. Yep. Okay, let's try it again. And the Doctor of Style truly has taught Kamala so much about life as a... Oh, that's a big, mean man.
Seems to have an attitude.
Yeah, he does, although he doesn't seem to be all that put out by the presence of the Nasty Boys, and for that matter, the mighty Kamala at all. Look at him.
He fears no one.
I think maybe you're right. Mr. Hughes surveying the situation, and it looks like Mr. Hughes is going to start off with the Ugandan Giant.
What a matchup this is.
Uh-oh, look at it. Look on the face of Kamala.
You know, I just had another idea.
What's that?
After the Slickster watches this, he may want to manage Mr. Hughes and dump that bum Kamala.
I hardly think he is a bum. Oh, wait a minute. Well, now what's this?
Oh, that was very interesting.
They decided to give Kamala a chance. I felt sorry for him, obviously.
Right, wait a minute. In the hand of the Million Dollar Man, look at this. Look at him peel off those C notes. Look at all of that money. Look at that money. Look at that.
Yeah. What did he say right there? What did he say?
I don't know. Was it English or Ugandanese? And it's like, okay, take the money and take off. DiBiase up to his own tricks again. The Million Dollar Man trying to buy off the mighty Kamala. Then from there, it'd be 3-on-2. It would be a handicap tag team matchup.
Take the money and run.
Oh. Kamala's taking the money. I can't believe it.
Why is DiBiase giving him the money?
Kamala takes the money and Kamala takes off. No, he doesn't take off. Kamala chops to DiBiase.
Awesome. The deal's not closed until it's closed.
The Million Dollar Man chopped down to the canvas again. Kamala double crossed Ted DiBiase to the back off. And moving right back in, the Ugandan Giant Ted DiBiase being ripped from pole to post.
Give me a telephone, I need to call the police.
Why?
I witnessed the theft.
You did not either.
I witnessed the theft.
DiBiase shouldn't have had that money in the first place.
No, the Slickster just stole this man's money.
He did not steal it. You know very well that money is going in the collection plate at the Mount Ephraim Baptist Church in Fort Worth, Texas this Sunday. You know very well that's where it's going.
I just saw it go in the Slickster's pocket.
Yeah. It'll wind up in the collection plate. Oh, look at this. And now, hammering away all over Ted DiBiase. And DiBiase whipped again to the buckle. Oh, what a clothesline. Six-man tag team match, and Ted DiBiase having big problems in this matchup. Two.
I guess so. Two is right. He's having a fight. Two against one.
DiBiase lost some money. He took a chance. It's like gambling in the stock market. If you lose, you lose.
Reversal now by DiBiase. And a knee to the midsection. Finally, DiBiase tags in IRS. IRS drops the misses the elbow. He's been nasty.
A very good effort on the part of Money Incorporated. And Mr. Hughes yet to get into the matchup. Look at this. Triple team effort. Oh, no. Come on, a little confused. Very much confused after that. Finally, here comes Mr. Hughes. Hughes hammering away on Kamala, knocks him down. Big, strong hombre, and Mr. Hughes.
Come on, Kamala.
Curtis Hughes hammering away on Kamala. Kamala chopping back. A bit of a slugfest here, developing between these two behemoths. Off the rope, Kamala. And no one goes anywhere. Look at this. And again. Another touch. Down goes Hughes finally.
What a matchup.
Fire knobs in now against Mr. Hughes. Double team effort. You're going to have to do something against this big man. Hughes, one of the more sought after individuals. Look at that. Hughes shoved Brian Knobs into the waiting Money Incorporated.
A little taste of their own medicine there. They've been double and triple teaming Mr. Hughes and Ted DiBiase and Irwin Arshiser all night long.
Mr. Hughes now with Brian Knobs off the rope, setting him up. Big boot right into the proboscis. Curtis Hughes with the advantage, likely to keep it.
You know, usually when you hit one of those slaps in the nose, you also break his finger.
That's not very nice to say.
But it's true.
Have you ever been nasty-sized?
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
I'd like to see that. Then again, I'd like to see you enter the King of the Ring tournament. More on that later on. Wide open now, Brian Knobs. From the second rope down into the facial area.
That should do it.
Oh, you're not going to hurt the nasty boys by hitting them in the head. And again, hammering away, Ted DiBiase. Big shot. Your analysis of the matchup thus far, Macho Man. Boom!
Get ready for another pit stop, DiBiase. We gave one to IRS. Let's do it for DiBiase also.
I mean, after all, those greenbacks should be good for something other than, I can't think of a better thing than the collection plate this coming Sunday. And you know the Reverend Slick's going to be there with the green.
DiBiase made a donation. I think well of him now.
Yeah, I do too. It's a very nice thing for him to do. Reaching for the tag, Irwin R. Scheister. Scheister ran in, Knobs able to tag his partner, Jerry Sags. Sags wailing away.
He's ready.
Sags setting up an RS, boot to the midsection, and here we go. Big pile driver. Perfectly executed. One, two, and Hughes helps out.
That would have been a three count right there if it wasn't for Hughes.
Would be extremely angry. Slick has the patience of Job explaining the facts of life to Kamala. Let's take you now face to face.
Okay, Champion Hulk Hogan. Last time, we would not be prepared. My man went 20 hot minutes with Bret Hitman Hart. That's right, 20 hot minutes. Yes, you were a fresh man. But this time, boy son, my man is prepared. Physically and mentally, he's prepared just for you, Hulk Hogan. He's gonna tear you apart. piece by piece, and that belt will come back to my Yokozuna. Come beat in Ohio, June 13th, for the King of the Ring. He'll be the King of the Ring. He will be the new WWF Heavyweight Champion. You mark my word, Hogan, you will pay.
You know, they actually had the gall to make me qualify for the King of the Ring. And, of course, poor Bob Backlund ended up paying the price. I really kind of feel sorry for him. But what I'm really looking forward to is that number one seed, because I will be the final chapter. I will put an end to the career of Bret the Hitman Hart.
Sensational one! From this day forth, I will haunt your very breath. I will be your shadow in the darkness. And then soon, very, very soon, I will wipe you from this earth. And I, Luna Vashon, I will be the goddess of the squared circle.
At WrestleMania, Luna Vashon, you attack me from behind, and then, on top of that, you come back in the emergency room after you almost break every rib in my body. You want a piece of me, little girl? Well, come and get it, because you're looking at a woman that invented mean, and you want some of me anywhere, anytime, one-on-one.
Here we go, a qualifying round. The winner of this matchup will be seated in the King of the Ring tournament. Just who will be the King of the Ring? This man thinks that he's the King of the Streets.
Razor Ramon, you think that he's going to the squared circle in a hurry, or do you think he's taking his time?
Oh, he likes to just take his time and ooze. That's machismo.
You know what? Speaking of time, it's a shame to see all of the WWF superstars wasting their time trying to get into this King of the Ring tournament.
Wasting your time?
It's a waste of time for them.
I see.
They're proving nothing. I am already the King of the Ring. Anybody that wins this tournament will be merely a pretender to my throne.
I see. Said so well. Said so well for an individual who won't even have enough gumption as of yet to attempt to qualify.
Is gumption the same as guts?
Very close, sir. A little bit lower and a little bit off to the side.
Oh, by the head.
Yeah. Razor Ramon.
And from the
body. Oh, yeah, here we go.
Lead.
Chiquita Banana. I can hardly wait.
El Matador. Tito Santana.
El Matador.
Give him one El Paso de Morte. And I think Razor Ramon will get beat. 1, 2, 3, and advance to the King of the Ring tournament. Which king, Jerry Lawler?
You know, you're right.
Got the guts.
There's a good chance that Razor can lose this match. He might slip on a banana peel. Let you keep the banana.
The king is really, 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 really well.
That probably would equate to his wrestling skills.
Well, I think his singing's a little bit better than that.
Well, you got a point. Nonetheless, El Matador ready to lock up with Razor Ramon. And look at Razor Ramon, who is being taunted a bit by El Matador.
This is a big matchup between two big superstars in the World Wrestling Federation.
El Toro, huh? Aha! Tito Santana, longtime favorite of the fans all over the World Wrestling Federation.
A lot of people pulling for Tito Santana, El Matador, right now against Razor Ramon. I know why.
Santana has the wrestling skill. He has the quickness, the agility, and the all-around power. Razor and, looking for the switch.
And the guts and the gumption to get in the qualifying.
Say that certainly those qualities relate to Santana, but not necessarily to our broadcast colleague.
Jerry Lawler.
Well, he's the only one around.
Reverse psychology won't work. I've told you that before.
You're right. You're not smart enough to get it.
Oh, yeah, right. You're right about one thing. Everybody's pulling for Tito Santana to get ahead, aren't they? Nobody likes the one he's got. Look at the head. Ooh, look at that. Even the Razor don't like it.
Oh, he's hammering the head is what he's doing.
Yeah.
Razor Ramon taunting El Matador. I never thought I'd see this. Missing with a roundhouse right. Santana connects. That'll do it right there.
Big four.
Get up. Oh. He's got it.
awesome. I didn't see that foot go over the rope. I thought we had a victory right there.
Santana going full well the way to this matchup. Likewise for Razor Ramon.
He's dazed. He's leading the ropes.
And a hard and attempted. Look at this. Right in midair. Razor's having big, big problems. And El Matador taking care of business.
Yeah, what Banana's fixing to do is make the Razor mad.
Oh, I see.
That's right.
Razor Ramon is oozing with problemas. Problems. Yes.
Thanks for that interpretation.
That's okay.
The king didn't understand.
He's not bilingual.
No, I guess he's not.
He doesn't even know English.
He's working on it.
You guys just talk amongst yourselves over there, okay?
Thank you very much.
I think that's what we're doing, yeah.
Oh, it's a rope right outside, misses. Santana connects again. Tito Santana winding up the big Razor, having his problems. Are you surprised thus far, Mr. Lawler, with the outcome of the match?
He's just toying with him. The Razor's just toying with
him. You're right. El Matador's toying with Razor Ramon. He's going to start leaning at him now.
When the Razor gets mad, he could end the career. This could be the Chiquita Banana's last match right here in the WWF.
Oh, look at that maneuver.
That's right.
Head hook.
Right across the throat, the top rope. And Razor Ramon getting very, very lucky with the use of that top rope there. And now taking full advantage.
All right, now we got an equal match right here. Who's ever got that,
the gumption you spoke of earlier.
And the guts, yeah, right. Yes.
Yeah. Just a little bit lower to the left. That's it. Razor Ramon hammering away.
You know, if this is the Matador's last match in the WWF, he's already got a second job lined up.
Look like that.
He helps his fellow Mexicans enter the United States illegally. He does.
Oh, you know how he does it. Forearm. Down goes Razor Ramon. Say what you will. Santana's ready for this. A big slam. Santana with the momentum. Santana trying to set up. Yes, he does again. Razor Ramon.
Come on, Razor.
Go for the cover, Tito. Like that.
Razor Ramon victorious. Brady Luck on his shoulders. Let's go back to the replay.
Yeah, watch this.
Yeah, watch this. This is a wrestling move, but it finishes up by cheating. Look at that. Look at the tights.
No way.
My hand full of tights. Right there. Yeah, watch this.
Nonetheless, chalk up a victory for Razor Ramon as we take you now. Base.
Ladies and gentlemen, my guest this week stands nearly 8 feet tall, accompanied by Harvey Whippleman. Here's the giant Gonzalez!
An awesome creature, 8 feet tall. Giant Gonzalez, and he has a bad disposition to match his overall height and girth. He is indeed a giant among men.
May have a bad disposition, but he's got a great little manager there.
A great manager, huh?
I love Harvey.
Harvey hoping to manage Mr. Hughes.
Yeah.
He's really in the vibe.
Harvey Whippleman, right here next week, your Giant Gonzalez will face the Native American Tatanka. And I state, you have not seen the last of The Undertaker.
Well, that's just for now, Raymond Rougeau. You've got to realize that, yes, I admit that The Undertaker has kept on and kept on and kept on coming back. But that's not because of guts. That's not because of tenacity. That's because of sheer stupidity. That's because he doesn't have enough sense to realize that when he signs for one more match with the Giant Gonzalez, that will, in fact, be his final match. When The Undertaker gets carried out again, he's not going to get up and come back, because when he gets carried out again, Raymond Rougeau, he's going to be carried out to stay once and for all. I promise you that. And as far as Tatanka, the Native American, is concerned, he's only going to be the next in a long, long line of opponents who are going to be destroyed, decapitated, and eliminated from the World Wrestling Federation by the Giant Gonzalez. Because, Mr. Rougeau, Tatanka really thinks that he's going to advance in the King of the Ring tournament by stepping in the ring with the Giant Gonzalez. But I've got news for that red-headed idiot. When he does step in the ring with the superhuman, 8-foot-tall, 443-pound Giant Gonzalez, he's going to be knocked out of that tournament and knocked clear out of the WWF. Tell him, Giant.
Goodbye, India.
There you have it. Next week, Giant Gonzalez, all 8 feet of him, squaring off against Tatanka in a qualifying round for the King of the Ring tournament right here.
You should really be ashamed of yourself. Wanting a gift for yourself for Mother's Day. You should go out and buy your mom something real nice. Well, I think she might debate that point with you. It came right down to it. And one thing's for sure, Bobby, this guy right here is not nice whatsoever.
Not at all. She better give me something nice. I own the mortgage on her home.
This is a very high-stakes matchup, to say the least. A qualifying match for the King of the Ring tournament, Papa Shango. 330 pounds, a real powerhouse. Putting my money on my good buddy. And right there he is, Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
That's right, the man who rides in the pickup truck with you. A big loud mouth. One thing I hate, Ross, that's a guy with a big mouth.
Man, listen to this crowd. They are behind this man, Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
You will find through life that most humanoids will back another humanoid.
Big Hacksaw makes his way to the ring. He's going to give up a few pounds here to Papa Shango.
I won't be pulling Shango's hair, we know that.
Hacksaw Duggan proudly displaying the red, white, and blue of Old Glory. And with that trusty 2x4 in hand.
Everyone's making a big deal out of Luger's arm. But they let that moron carry a 2x4 in the ring. Oh, and say nothing to him.
Papa Shango nailing Hacksaw from behind. And hammers
him.
He hammered him with a headbutt. Right hand by Papa Shango. Starting out very aggressively here in the early going.
Hard to keep Duggan down, isn't it?
Well, he's a real fierce competitor. Reverses the whip. And rocks Papa Shango, but doesn't take him down.
Not yet.
He rocks him again. And Hacksaw getting some additional momentum. And plants him this time with that clothesline.
Oh, he loves the people, don't he?
He really does. He genuinely will sign autographs all day long if necessary. I've seen him stand after a match outside the arenas and sign for every little...
You know why?
Why?
Because he can't get the name right the first couple times. He has to keep going over and over until he gets it right.
Irish whip. Where do you come up from?
Oh,
set a little early. Set a little bit early there and got hammered.
Well, like I said, the guy's not the brightest guy walking the streets.
Graduated from Southern Methodist University in Dallas.
Wow! Those are credentials.
Outstanding university, and Papa Shonda trying to find a hump out of Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
Ever hear of UCLA?
Yes, Bob.
Thank you.
And you're trying to infer, you know, make me believe that you attended that university? Los Angeles, California.
Right down the street from where I live. A couple miles.
Shango, the headbutt, lower abdomen. And Shango has been extremely aggressive in this contest.
Well, he knows what it is to get in that King of the Ring tournament, and he's got to get by Duggan to get in there. That means a lot of prestige and a lot of money for a lot of people.
We know that Bret Hart is the number one seed in that tournament. Lex Luger qualified last week, and he beat Bob Backlund.
How about that main event?
Oh, man, that is going to be something.
Yokozuna goes for the gold again.
Yeah, Hulk Hogan, what a challenge for the Hulkster against the 505-pound Yokozuna, as Papa Shango has that huge arm and a rear chin lock. And he's
not choking. It looks like a choke, but he's not.
Referee Danny Davis, right, great position to see if it was a choke. Apparently it isn't. Shango using that 330-pound weight to try to crimp the neck of Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
You know what's great about wrestling Papa Shango? If you get him in the right hold, you can also read him.
He has some rather bizarre tattoos. A lot of them, as a matter of fact. We'll see another man with a tattooed head later in this broadcast.
Bam, bam.
And Shango used the hair to take Duggan back down, and of course he's going to deny it.
Come on, squeeze him, squeeze him. Squeeze the beard right off that ugly face.
Shango's an extremely strong athlete.
And who knows what he's going to come up with. You know, he can do some strange things. Real strange.
Hacksaw Duggan finds himself in a very defensive situation here. He's got to come up with a counter brain.
Yeah, give up.
Well, he'll never do that.
Too dumb to give up. See, the secret is when you say, I give up, then when he releases the hole, you grab the referee before he rings the bell and say, I'm just kidding. And you turn around and you really walk with a guy.
Oh, Papa Shango buried the knee right into the old breadbasket of Hacksaw Jim Duggan, and down Hack goes one more time.
He's ahead on points so far.
Irish whip, far side. Duggan in trouble here. Papa Shango.
Taking too much time.
And Shango found nobody at home on that particular maneuver. And Big Hacksaw, those big hams, finding their mark, rights and lefts, has Papa Shango reeling. Jim Duggan down the three-point stands and runs right through. Papa Shango hooks the leg. And Duggan wins it. Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
He's in now, right?
Is in the King of the Ring tournament.
Hacksaw.
He'll mark June 13th on his calendar. Fans young and old alike.
And who's going to read it to him?
I said he went to UCF. You got me confused. He went to SMU.
Hey, same to you.
Jim Duggan got good hands too. Watch these hands.
Well, where do you think you are, little dweeb?
Hacksaw Jim Duggan advancing in the King to the King of the Ring tournament on June 13th.
Look out!
Fair catch. Good hand.
Hard to do with a guy that's watching a fly with one eye and you with the other.
Please, Bob. That's very, very impolite. Fans, there's a brand new feature for you.
She'll get me this year.
Looking on in awe at this very unique person, shall we say.
Miss Vachon, with all due respect, Sensational Sherry says that your days are numbered here in the World Wrestling Federation.
Sensational Sherry is nothing but an old hag. In fact, she is little more than a witch. She is just jealous of me. In fact, you are all jealous of me. And my pure natural beauty. 90s. In fact, using mere words to describe me is like using a screwdriver to cut roast beef. Let it be known, when I step foot into the squared circle, I turn into a rabbit mad dog. And sensational Sherry, when I stink my things into you, I will tear you to shreds.
She's sick. She is a sick human being.
Beautiful.
Mr. Fuji, very well familiar with the sands of time. Hulk Hogan, very familiar with Yokozuna. As a matter of fact, he is listening right now. Hulkster, what in the world are you hearing?
Well, you know me, Gene. As the white Bengal tiger, the Hulkster himself, puts his ear down to the sands, brother, on Venice Beach, California, all the way down to Clearwater, Florida, on the sands here, I hear the fear in Yokozuna in Mr. Fuji's walk, brother. As they strut through Tokyo, Japan, as they strut through the markets buying the stinky fish, they realize Hulk Hogan has had it with Hollywood, brother. They realize Hulk Hogan is going back to the ring. And the only reason I'm coming back, brother, is to prove that winning the belt for the fifth time, brah, was no fluke. That winning the belt for the fifth time was destiny, brother. That winning the belt for the fifth time proves that Hulkamania will live forever. Do you doubt my words?
Not for a minute, as of course we have talked about in recent weeks. Initially, after WrestleMania 9, the big protest, the big brouhaha. And then the decision of President Jack Tunney. However, all along, Mr. Fuji has contended that he was robbed. This title was stolen from him and Japan.
Well, I'm not worried about the brouhaha or anybody drinking brouhahas. I've been on the brink of disaster, man, drinking my own sweat to survive, waiting for Jack Tunney to decide should he or shouldn't he strip the belt from the immortal Hulk Hogan. But even if he did take the belt from me, which he didn't, I would have ripped it right back off Yokozuna's waist. What you gonna do when the strongest force of Hulkamania runs wild on you?
You know, I told all my fans that have been supporting me that I was gonna get right back on track, and that's exactly what I'm gonna do. I'm the first seed in the King of the Ring tournament. And all I know is I don't have an opponent yet. And you know something? I don't care. I don't care who it is, because whoever it is, you will be excellently executed by the best there is, the best there was, and the best there ever will be.
Oh! Hey, folks, Papa Shango went down, and it wasn't a wrestling match. It was a fight. Now the King of the Ring is in sight, and old Hacksaw Jim Duggan's strategy is attack, 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 and never quit. Tough guy!
Mr. Perfect! Next week we get to meet in the ring for the second time! You're perfect, so what does that make me? You're equal! Now it's for the King of the Ring! And it's serious this time, I was playing with you last time! But now, there is no clowning around!
Doink, you consider yourself equal to Mr. Perfect? You didn't look too perfect when I had you in the perfect plex and the bell saved you. Well, next week we're gonna do it again. And I guarantee you, there will be no bell to save you.
It's raw talent that's got me to the top of the World Wrestling Federation. And tonight, Hacksaw Jim Duggan is gonna find out why I'm the World Wrestling Federation Intercontinental Champion.
Yeah!
fucking busy asshole! Do it!
Scheduled for one fall is a qualifying match for the World Wrestling Federation King of the Ring Tournament. Introducing first from Asbury Park, New Jersey, weighing 390 pounds, Bam Bigelow!
Trouble tonight.
Well, this is for the King of the Ring qualifying. Guess what, Typhoon? He wants it big time, man. I talked to him already.
Bam Bam waiting patiently for his opponent. The building starts to rock. The building starts to shake. Hold on, into the ring.
Can you imagine two men this size going for it? They're going for the honor to be in the King of the Ring. My money's on Bam Bam. Bam Bam looks more intense. He's pacing. He's walking back and forth. He is ready.
Over 700 pounds in the squared circle, not counting the official. There's, of course, a qualifying match for the King of the Ring tournament to be held on Sunday, June 13th.
I got a question for you. Who's got the weight advantage here, or does it matter?
Typhoon by a hair. Off the rope. Big Bam Bam.
Boom!
Nobody goes anywhere. Bam Bam Bigelow. Typhoon. Talk about the beef. Take a look at it here in the WWF. And again, no one goes anywhere.
Looks like two 18-wheelers on the interstate hitting head-on.
Both men wanting to qualify for the King of the Ring tournament. Off the rope, Bam Bam. And again, shoulder lock, and no one goes anywhere.
The irresistible force versus the immovable object.
Typhoon coming underneath now. And trying to really get underneath and down.
Whoa!
Now we're
I've ever
started.
Seen Bigelow slam.
There's a lot you haven't seen. You're going to see it tonight.
Savage, you give me any more trouble, I'm going to have to ask you to leave.
Would you please?
He starts on me, Vince, all the time.
Yeah,
I'm jealous of me. He picks
I
on
hate
me.
It when he talks that.
Get a life.
Typhoon now with a rest lock here on Big Bam Bam Bigelow. The winner of this matchup continues. They will qualify for the King of the Ring. And a scoop here in the snow. He can't quite. Well, he does. Slams him across the elbow. And Bam Bam just able to get Typhoon off. Oh, look at this, and misses. Both men tenacious. Both men want to be a part of the King of the Ring tournament. A headbutt.
That's using your head, dummy.
If it works, why not?
That's right. That's what I always say.
Yeah.
You have to. Nah, never mind.
Yeah, well, I'll tell you one thing. We are likely to see the Intercontinental title change hands right here tonight. On Monday Night Raw, Jack Tunney, president of the WWF, forcing Shawn Michaels to once again return, justifiably return, and defend the title in this most unusual manner. And if you've never seen a lumberjack match, you're in for a treat. Randy Savage, you've been in a number of them.
Absolutely. Shawn Michaels' intentions were good, mouthing off in front of the Manhattan Center, but his timing was...
Whoa! What a suplex!
I'll tell you something, Savage.
Tell me one thing.
I always thought you did this, but I know.
Look at this, all the way to the outside now.
But I know Tunney can be bought. I know Tunney, you can grease his palm real easy. That's why I think Hacksaw Jim Duggan did this.
Wait a minute. Typhoon to the outside now. Typhoon. Oh, Bam Bam back in.
Nail. There. Good move.
To the head. Typhoon hammering away. Come on, ref. Get in there. Do your job.
Oh, no! Typhoon in the ring post, down on the metal steps to the outside.
That's going to be a tough one to come back from right there, Typhoon.
It just shows you how bad everybody wants to be in the King of the Ring. I'm sorry for interrupting you. I didn't mean to. Excuse me. I'm very sorry. Thank you.
And again, attempt to get back into the ring. Greeted with another hammer there. Typhoon.
It looks to me like the top of Bam Bam's head's been busted open a bit.
I would imagine that's just a tattoo. Oh, and again, it seems to me if anyone's going to be busted open, it's going to be the big man, Typhoon.
Rough start for Typhoon.
384 pounds on him.
Absolutely.
Look how tough this Bam Bam Bigelow is.
What?
I mean, he's got like a 3 or 4 inch gash in his head. He doesn't even affect him. He is one tough customer.
Yes. Now you've got a point there at the top of the head. Now we can see, yes, the gash. That's not a tattoo. However,
and it's not a palmetto bug either.
Typhoon suffering the consequences of the attack of Bam Bam Bigelow.
to the big men, slowing down both of them, Typhoon a bit more.
Bam Bam may punch himself out. You never know how this is going to turn out.
Well, you know what slows Typhoon down, don't you?
What's that?
Twinkie.
I beg your pardon?
Hostess Cupcakes, then. I'm sorry.
Bam Bam, notice how he's using his weight to his advantage, leaning down on Typhoon, applying pressure in every way.
He uses his weight to his advantage at dinner.
That's 360 pounds, and look at this. Typhoon trying to come out of it, turning into his man.
Whoa!
To the corner, nice maneuver. Typhoon trying to once again mount an offensive, beating him to the punch or to the kick, rather. There is Bam Bam Bigelow. Bam Bam, the reverse front face lock, and the matchup will continue when we return with more Monday Night Raw. Welcome back to more Monday Night Raw. We are live at the Manhattan Center. This is the qualifying matchup for the King of the Ring, and these two have been going at it. Back and forth, seesaw matchup. Bam Bam for the ride now to the buckle. Typhoon moving in, and Bam Bam getting out of there.
You know, I'm very surprised that two
big... Wait a minute, look at this.
On
the back. What a maneuver by Bam Bam. Yes.
Give Bam Bam credit right there.
Bam Bam to the outside now. Bam Bam perhaps thinking he can finish off Typhoon.
Third floor.
Bam Bam going up to the top. 360 pounds to the top rope. Down.
He's got him. He's got him.
Mark.
Deserves it. Deserves it.
One, two,
Bam Bam's in.
Yes,
he's in the King of the Ring. Yes.
Qualified for the King of the Ring tournament. And did you notice exactly the way he polished off Typhoon? It was reminiscent of someone else by the name of Tatanka.
The Native American, yes, you're right. And Tatanka, I'm sure, is going to be watching that, but it doesn't matter. Bottom line, Bam Bam's in the King of the Ring tournament.
Victorious Bam Bam Bigelow. There's a tag team combination knocking on the door of the WWF.
Conducted by, making her debut in the WWF, Miss Bonnie Blackstone.
My guest this week is certainly an object of spectacle here in the World Wrestling Federation. Ladies and gentlemen, the narcissist, Lex Luger. Definition, vascularity, size, and one can't help but notice, ladies and gentlemen, these two screws which seem to protrude from your skin area, screws which in fact hold a 6-inch steel plate in place in your forearm. Does this not give you an unfair advantage over opponents here in the World Wrestling Federation?
You know, we really don't need to get into that. The ruling's been made, the decision's been handed down, and that's it.
Mr. Luger, let me remind you that several referees have taken it upon themselves to demand that you wear a protective covering over this forearm in World Wrestling Federation matches. I know this doesn't bode well with you.
Let's not stir up anything that doesn't need to be stirred up. The decision's been made, and it's final. They're powerless.
But Mr. Luger, we have spoken with the fans of the World Wrestling Federation who demand that all referees deem it necessary for you to cover this 6-inch steel plate in all future matchups. This is almost like carrying a baseball bat to the ring. This thing might as well be a brick, sir.
Well, who do you think you are coming out here the first week in the World Wrestling Federation? I don't care what any of these stinking fans think. I don't care what the officials or Jack Tunney think. Because nobody, and I mean nobody, tells the narcissist Lex Luger what he can and can't do. Because I am going to the very top of the World Wrestling Federation. And I will knock out anybody who gets in my way, even if I didn't have a steel plate. I will step on anyone who gets in my way, especially you, Bret Hart, because I am going to be the man in the World Wrestling Federation, and I don't care who I have to knock out to do it.
Yo, Hitman, you so fired up. You so upset. You really happy? You got a face Razor Ramon? Chico, you on a losing streak, man. You a loser. Now, take a look at the bad guy. I on a roll, Chico. I already carved up one opponent. And Hitman, you are next.
All right, it's pick'em time. On his way to the square circle, this 8-foot creature. I've got a question for you, King. Who wins the matchup? Who advances in the King of the Ring tournament? Is it the Giant Gonzalez or is it Tatanka?
I don't know. I'm too busy looking at the Macho Man. You said it's pick'em time and he's got his finger in his nose.
I'll pick you to leave the planet Earth in about 10 seconds.
Let
me do it, Vince McMahon. Just one shot. Bang, zoom to the moon.
Let's just stay with the broadcast.
Okay. You want me to pick the winner in this match? There it is, right there.
Why?
There it is, right
Why?
There.
Why?
Why? Just look at him. 8 feet tall.
$400. No, he's not 500. That Joe goes to him. He's over 400.
I think he's approaching 500. He's getting bigger every day. Look at him.
He is an awesome creature. Whoa, but wait a minute.
Oh, I hate that sound.
You know where the fan support lies. Here he is on his way.
This guy right here knows it's not over till it's over. What? Do the impossible. Mission impossible. Take the big man down. Beat him, Tataka. Yeah.
And look at this. Giant Gonzalez ushering Tataka into the ring. And the look on the kisser of Tataka is one of awe and appreciation, as it should be.
That Tataka, he made that sound like a screech owl. He ran all the way to the ring and he saw his opponent and he screeched on the brakes, didn't he?
You know, I have to agree with that, Vince McMahon. That was a little bit different the way Tataka came
into
the ring.
Well, you can see a lot of the hair missing there. Tataka has not grown back from the melee that Tataka and Bam Bam had back in the dressing room area some weeks past. Now it is time for Tataka to bring with him all of the spirits of his forefathers in this insurmountable task. Oh, look at that.
Scratch one or two forefathers. Tell him, Harvey.
This is the qualifying matchup. Whoever wins this matchup will continue on and will be in the King of the Ring tournament.
And wait a minute.
What?
Do I just remember that Tataka is still undefeated?
You've got that right. Playing the undefeated streak on the line. Look at this awesome giant.
Stay tuned, everybody. You're fixing to see history in the making.
Well, you'll see history in the making, no doubt, when The Undertaker gets his mitts on the Giant Gonzalez, that's for sure.
So you're admitting right now that Tataka's not going to be able to get the job done, huh?
It's doubtful. It's doubtful. I'll agree with you there.
Man handling Tataka.
Look at the difference in the size. Tataka, 250-some-odd pounds. But look, he is dwarfed in comparison.
Twice as tall, twice as heavy.
Oh, I'll tell you what, I'll give you a good excuse for Tataka. Maybe he's like the mighty Samson. When he got his hair cut off, he lost all his strength.
Tataka for the ride, off the rope. Big boot by this awesome giant Gonzalez.
Did anybody like you when you were growing up, King?
Anybody like you?
Not
him.
Even
Does anybody
your mama.
Like now?
No, I just wanted to know. Thought crossed my mind.
Yeah, if a thought ever came in your mind, it would die of loneliness.
Come on, Tataka firing off to the midsection. Tataka caught the giant upstairs earlier.
Hell, let's chop the big tree down.
Oh, look,
chop that giant sequoia down. Go to work on the knee. Tataka now, high risk maneuver going upstairs. Going to the top rope. Tataka now from the top rope.
A big chop across the back of the head. Tataka goes for it again. Look at this.
You can't knock that man off his feet.
Yes, you can, dude. Tataka down again. The giant will fall.
Tataka.
Look, he's got him by the neck.
Giant Gonzalez with his favorite hold. It's the most punishing hold that he knows. He chokes and saps the strength right out of you. This is tantamount to disqualify. The referee just went down. Disqualify. Come on, Red. Disqualify.
He didn't fall down. He was pushed by Giant Gonzalez.
Disqualify him. That's it. No. I think he disqualified him. Count him out.
Still undefeated to Tonka. Not by means where he would want it to be. Tournament in the first place.
He wants to make a reputation for himself. He wants to choke everybody out of the WWF. The Undertaker, Tataka, I guess it really doesn't matter. This is a mean 8-foot giant.
These guys is in a completely different light now.
Tataka!
I'm shocked. This is too much. You are something
Tataka,
else,
yeah,
brother.
Tataka advances. He will be in the tournament. Well, he feels like a winner at this moment. Thumbs down for this 8 foot 400 plus giant Gonzalez. Tataka is hurting. Nonetheless, it still remains an undefeated streak on the part of Tataka. But take it face to face.
Right here next week, a non-title match to see who qualifies for King of the Ring. Me and you, Crush. See, I'm the IC champ. I shouldn't have to qualify. I'm already the king. But you're gonna find out, being big doesn't make you good. Being good makes you good.
You are Shawn Michaels. You keep telling everybody about how good you are.
Well, I agree with you, brother. You are good.
Good for nothing. I may have you in a non-title match, but this match is very, very important. This match determines on who goes on in the tournament of the King of the Ring. I'll beat you, Shawn Michaels. I'll show you I'm not only big, but I'm good too, bruh. Shock.
I got my 2x4. I got the American flag. You're in the back of the dressing room and you're lacing up your boots and you're kind of thinking, geez, this guy I'm wrestling today is going to be awful tough. You know he's over in the other dressing room. He's big, he's young, and he's strong, and he wants to make his name beating up old Hacksaw. So sometimes I do get a little apprehensive. But then right before I go through the curtain, I got the American flag over my shoulder.
USA!
American flag, American flag.
Potential. There's absolutely no doubt about that.
Dan Farron
will challenge the 360-pounder. We talked about his athletic ability and double thrust right there.
Looks like he should work for a collection agency, don't he?
I think he used to be a bodyguard or something. I know he was a great college football player at Kansas State. Drop kick.
Look at that. 360 pounds right up there. 5-6 feet up there in the air.
And that... that look on his face pretty well tells how he feels about things.
He either hates the world or he's sucking on a 4-pound lemon.
I think the former as opposed to the latter. I don't think he likes anybody.
No, I don't either. Ooh, look at that. He just smothers you.
You got to be impressed, though, with his athletic ability, his quickness. There's a lateral press there. And he's just dominated Dan Farron here thus far in this contest. I haven't seen this guy really be challenged yet.
I haven't either. You know, and if I was still in the managing end of my profession, I could really rip, I mean, make a lot of money with this guy.
You had it right.
What?
Rip him off.
I didn't say rip him off.
You've done that.
I caught.
Oh, you had a sore throat this week?
Yeah, I got a
new Mercedes at the windows down. And
the top down, too. Another like buzzing through BH with the top down.
Silver spoon, Bobby the Brain Heenan.
I was not born with a silver spoon in my mouth. It was a whole place setting, and it was gold.
Following him right in. I'll tell you, as we said, everybody looking to sign this big man, including the evil Mr. Fuji.
Fuji? He's looking at him, too?
Sure is. Listen to this.
Mr. Hughes, Mr. Fuji, been observing you. Been looking you over. You are a very, very tough man. Oh, very tough. Mr. Fuji, you're making a lot of yen. You come with me, boy, son. You come with Mr. Fuji. A lot of yen.
Well, Fuji does a good deal when he sees one. There's no doubt about it.
Well, you know, the Japanese have bought over half of New York City. They own Radio City Music Hall and all that. They got nothing but money. Very smart, intelligent people. It wouldn't surprise me if Fuji didn't sign him.
Well, Mr. Hughes certainly has been dominant in each and every outing here in the World Wrestling Federation. A whip to the center of the ropes, far side, and two.
You know, you're right.
Side slam is just dominate.
Nobody's even pushed him yet.
Just no telling how good this man can be, fans. When we come back, a special King of the Ring report right after this.
If you don't know, let me refresh your memory. I beat the big man Typhoon, and that qualified me for the first round in King of the Ring. And none other than you, Jim Duggan. You and your 2x4 have been walking tall for too long. Now it's time for you to go down in flames.
Hey-oh! Bam Bam Bigelow, first round, King of the Ring, and you're out here blowing fire. Well, I think you're blowing smoke, tough guy. Who do you think you got? Some punk kid? This is Hacksaw Jim Duggan, and I'm coming after you. tough guy!
This is what it's all about at the King of the Ring on June 13th. We're just weeks away from the big showdown in Dayton, Ohio. World Wrestling Federation champion Hulk Hogan defending against the big 505-pound Japanese superstar Yokozuna. You are here with the mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart, your new and improved manager. Hulkster, before we talk titles, before we talk made-for-television movies, before we talk about anything else, what in the world is your Harley Davidson doing parked in the water here at the beach?
That's a sore subject with him, Mean Gene. You know, look at his motorcycle. He's going to get rust all of it. He don't want to talk about that.
Salt,
he
gets up to...
That's right, man.
Well, you know, just before I landed in the salt water, brother, I took her out of the shower. And as I was washing her down and stroking her tanks, as I wrapped the largest legs in the world around her gas tanks, brother, all of a sudden, I got hit between the eyes with a lightning bolt. And as I ran down to the shores of the Pacific Ocean, I put the front forks of my wide glide in about 3 feet of salt water. And with a palm tree in one hand and a hippie in the other, I looked to the big brother in the sky. And I said, in Dayton, Ohio, who's going to be King of the Ring? Ha ha. Guess what happened, Gino?
I want to know the answer.
The python started to swell. The veins down the pythons were filled with ice-cold water, brother. And as I felt the power of the Hulkamaniacs, as I felt the power of the pythons, and as I realized for the fifth time I was the greatest champion there ever was, ever is, or ever will be, I also realized that Yokozuna, 525 pounds of stench, wart-infested Japanese, was going over my head for the ride. And as I slammed him down in the center of the ring, he will bow to Hulkamania.
This should be a tremendous event. Remember, ladies and gentlemen, 2 weeks ago on Superstars, it was Mr. Perfect and Doink. They went to a time limit draw. This is the return matchup, and the loser will be eliminated from the King of the Ring competition.
Doink told me personally, he was just playing with him 2 weeks ago. He means business right now.
Well, if anyone in the World Wrestling Federation knows the abilities of Mr. Perfect, it would be you, Bobby, because you were very close with him at one time.
That's right. You know, and I'm not...
Before you ripped him off.
Before I didn't rip him off. He stabbed me in the back. Well, let me tell you something, and I'm going to be honest with you.
Oh, that'd be a switch. That's a novel idea.
Of course. Perfect, pound for pound, is the toughest guy in the World Wrestling Federation. He may be the toughest guy next to Andre that I've ever managed. But he's got a mean streak. You can't tell him what to do. He will not take directions. He will not listen. He's perfect as long as you listen to me. But you won't listen to me now? Forget him. But he's still pound for pound, probably the toughest guy in the World Wrestling Federation. But he's squirting the people. This guy's a million laughs.
I think he's rather morbid myself. Oh, he squirted a little kid. Can you believe that? He squirted a little boy with a stupid thing in it, flower, whatever it is. The little boy's upset, and Mr. Perfect's not going to stand for it. Perfect with right hands coming right down the aisle here to meet Doink the Clown. And takes his head right into the steps leading into the ring. Lacing the clown here. I don't like this clown at all.
You're upset, Ross.
That little boy was almost ready to cry.
Oh, that was water from the flower.
And what's that? Mr. Perfect right to work on the leg of Doink the Clown.
I just think that kid don't have to get his regular Saturday night bath now. You got it.
Perfect. Grapevine in the leg, tying it up. Almost down to an Indian deathlock.
Remember you and I were talking the other day. Doesn't Doink remind you of different wrestlers? You just can't put your finger on it.
Yes.
He's somebody we know, though, isn't he?
Yes. He has. But he reminds me of different people at different times, depending on the type of match that he's in.
Right. And then I'll see him do a move that I'll know somebody does. I'll say, that's it. Then the next thing he does, I know that wrestler that did the first move, couldn't do that, so it doesn't fit.
This is a submission maneuver, one of the oldest
maneuvers in. Oh, rake of the eyes. That's an old maneuver as well. The Indian Deathlock.
That's the best.
Certainly a submission maneuver. And Doink noticeably limping here. His mobility a little bit less than that. And he catches Mr. Perfect with a sleeper. Got the sleeper hold on Perfect.
He knows how to wrestle. He's not just some clown that wants to make people laugh and have a good time. He's here for a reason. He wants some gold.
Well, his packaging is very deceiving. Tremendous crowd on hand here again this week. And we're happy that you're with us. And again, Perfect focusing back on the leg.
That's the mark of a good head wrestler. You go back to the same hold. No matter what else happens, if you start out working on one part of the body, you better continue with it. You wear the man down. He can't run on one leg. He can't kick you with one leg. He can't fight with one leg. So you take the other leg out. Very simple. It's all mathematical. Just a, you know what I mean.
Well, I think I know what you mean, and I think Doink knows what Mr. Perfect means, and he means business.
He certainly does.
The loser of this match will be eliminated from the King of the Ring competition, as we mentioned. So this is a must-win situation for both these athletes. Perfect really reaching back on that knee, trying to stretch the ligaments there.
Look at this.
Step over leg lock. Doink finally able to counter, but look at Perfect right back on that leg, single leg picked up, and a spinning toe hold.
And he didn't get up. He didn't get himself in a position where he could have got hurt. He crawled behind him and snapped it and pointed to the figure four.
Perfect has the figure four. He's got it perfectly executed. Doink the clown in a great deal of pain, in danger of having to give it up here.
I'd give it up.
They say that the figure four puts tremendous pressure on 7 points of the legs.
Eight.
Oh, is it eight?
Well, 7 points.
I knew I would be wrong. You would be right.
7 points on the leg and the other points in your wallet.
But Perfect has the figure four and Doink dangerously close to the ropes. He gets the ropes. Referee's got to, there he has.
There, he made it. He made it.
There will be the break. But the damage may have already been done here, Brain.
Now, the longer you're in it, the worse it gets.
And Doink.
See, Doink knew where he was. He knew he was only a couple feet from the ropes. If he grabbed Perfect, he could kind of pull him out. Trosha, he's a veteran. He knows what he's doing.
But he can barely stand. And he takes Perfect full face first into the steps. His head just smacked the top of the ring steps there. And Doink may win this one by count out. I'm not so sure Perfect can get back in the ring.
I don't think so either. He's a competitor. He wants to fight. And he wants to win. He wants that money.
And here Doink one more time takes him to those steel steps. And Perfect in a tremendous amount of trouble here.
I think he got his hand there this time. He didn't get him as good as he did the first.
Doink again.
Oh, he got him good that time.
Limping, slamming it. Perfect's head again into the steps. Doink the clown in control here.
Take him apart, Doink. Do something funny. Make me laugh. Take his arm off.
Perfect trying to grab the ropes and does. Brings his way back up on the apron. Back in the ring.
Nail him.
Oh. Ooh.
Oh.
Hard forearm right across the chest.
That'll stop your Timex.
Handful of hair. And takes Perfect's head into the top turnbuckle. We are seeing the bona fide mean streak that this individual possesses. Pulled his hair, took him down. Referee gonna break it?
He caught him.
Look at that.
I'm telling you, this guy can wrestle.
He could break his wrist that way.
Tear the elbow out. You can do a lot of damage that way. I like that one. I'm gonna do that on my shoulder when I get home.
Clothesline. From Doink, driving Perfect in the ropes. And again, back outside. This has been a very physically challenged matchup for both these athletes.
That's called taking out the garbage.
Perfect.
Watch the eyes on Doink. Watch his personality change.
He doesn't have a personality.
He's got about more of a human
being. Snapmare. And Perfect goes over. And down to the arm bar.
I asked him the other day, I said, Doink, where are you from? He said, where would you be from if it didn't matter?
Now, what does that mean?
I left it alone.
As I think you should. And there you see the features of this evil individual. Certainly cannot judge a book by its cover, as the old cliche goes. This guy is the just exact opposite of what a clown should be. Right hands.
Oh,
and both guys.
Here we go now.
Hammering each other, rights and lefts now from Doink. And down goes Perfect. Real gut check for Mr. Perfect here as he fights his way back up to a vertical base and nails Doink the clown with the right hand. And Doink fights back with a left of his own. Wait a minute, the bell sounds.
For what?
Tremendous offensive flurry to both men, but the bell is sounding. Have we gone to another time limit draw? What's the deal?
I don't understand it. Let me get a call in here. Referee!
There's the perfect plex, but...
Come on, will somebody give me an answer? What's going on here?
We need to get an official ruling here from the referee. What's going on? This could be the second time they have wrestled to a time limit draw.
Well, then they're both in the King of the Ring, then, right?
Oh, no, neither are. You got to win.
Ladies and gentlemen, the time limit has expired. The referee's decision. The match is a draw.
So that means Perfect is out and he's in, right?
No, Bob, it doesn't.
Watch the eyes. Look at this. He's happy. And then Snappo.
There's Luna.
Oh, that's perfect. Hard to tell them apart from the back.
Another time limit draw here.
Come on. We started it. Give me 5 more minutes, Bozo.
5
Bozo.
More minutes? Well, we need to have a winner here. Perfect's ready to get it on here. Let's see if Doink the Clown's got the guts to get back in the ring and continue the fight.
Are they going
to
give him 5 more minutes? I don't know. Will it count?
Well, the referee sanctions it. He has the authority to do that. And there's Doink trying to attack Perfect from behind.
Doink's gone.
Perfect down.
Next week, Kamala, King of the Ring, I am gonna leave the winner, Slick. Come on and get in my way. I got something for you because I am Mr. Hughes, and I guarantee you this one thing, you will go down. I promise you this. I am Mr. Hughes, the man.
You know, Mr. Hughes, Kamala and myself are men who walk in the light, and we walk on this title right. Welcome you to the World Wrestling Federation. And then we've heard those negative remarks that you made toward Kamala, Ugandan Giant. Well, next week in the King of the Ring contest, it will be the Ugandan Giant who advances.
Cool.
He's deceptive.
Yes, I have no question about that. Shawn Michaels, last Monday night, upset. It was a night of upset. Shawn Michaels losing the Intercontinental title to his old nemesis, Marty Jannetty.
Oh, look
and
at
I'm
this.
Sure, look at who. Oh, wow. What power possessed by Crush?
Tell you who else was upset was Bobby the Weasel Heenan on Monday Night Raw when it happened right there. He was livid.
Hey, If I tell him you're calling him the weasel, you're liable to be upset.
Oh, I'm really going to be in
Michael,
a lot of
trouble. Michael, now with a mighty crash. Now, nice reversal. Phil and Michael crash charges behind. Nice maneuver by Shawn Michaels. Michaels underneath the clothesline. He won't escape that maneuver.
Wow. Poor man look.
And a corner crash with a headbutt. Setting up Michaels. No reversal off the rope. Over Michaels. Right back at him. Crash catches him in midair. Look at that thumb in the eye. Good move. Good wrestling move.
I beg your pardon?
Good smart wrestling move there.
It's the only one the King knows.
Oh. Shawn Michaels and Crash going at it. The winner of this match will qualify for the King of the Ring tournament. There are two openings left.
Oh, can you imagine seeing this big pineapple hit with him?
Yeah, I can imagine that. Wait. But Shawn Michaels can't imagine that clothesline had no effect on Crash. Look at this. Michaels going up. Qualification was an eye gouge we saw earlier on.
No, he intentionally threw him over the top rope then.
Crush wants to be the King of the Ring.
Can you imagine him with a crown on his head? No way.
I can imagine most anyone with a crown on their head except, well,
Jerry Lawler. I'll say it.
Wait a minute, coming outside now, Crush. Put Shawn Michaels. And what's going to happen? Crush wants to win this matchup. He throws Michaels back in. Michaels backing off a bit. Look at the termination on the face of the original Hawaiian punch. Oh, yeah. Flat in the foot. From there, it's Michaels for the ride. Crush moving in. Oh, yeah. Michaels, the opportunist, driving an E-crush to the outside.
Crush's intentions were good, but his timing was bad.
Shawn Michaels, quite an athlete, taking nothing away from this man's prowess. Right now, it's...
Oh, no, the juicy back.
Yes, I did. I love it.
Metal steps.
That's an equalizer right there.
Michaels, oh, no, another one. Oh, to the ring post. Give me a break. You find humor in this?
I love this. I told you, it's no way that Shawn Michaels is going to lose two in a row. No way.
It appears to me these are desperate tactics on the part of a desperate man, Shawn Michaels. Michaels now with a handful of hair. Michaels pulling Crush back through the ropes. And the big Hawaiian is in a bit of trouble, no question about it. Shawn Michaels rules the day. He just can't believe what he did, the mistake he made by accepting the challenge and taking on Marty Jannetty last Monday night. He can't believe he made such a huge mistake.
He thinks he got a raw deal on Monday Night Raw. I don't think so. Thumbs up to Marty Jannetty.
Elbow by Crush. And another one. Crush off the rope and no catch in the floor. No. There's another. The spin.
The clothesline down he goes.
Crush trying to set up Shawn Michaels down. Across the rope, yes. Big boot. Shawn Michaels in yet more trouble. Down with a leg drop. And Crush is going to soon be in the King of the Ring tournament.
If he does, I'm going to jump 30 feet up into the air. Two in a row against Shawn. Michaels,
oh no, Michaels in more trouble. Michaels, oh, 3 points, field goal, another one.
I guess you call that legal wrestling.
And another one to the outside. Oh, I know, Shawn Michaels should not have been laying up there across the top rope taking a snooze like that. That was not fair.
I wish I was refereeing this match.
Oh no, elbow to the outside.
So let sleeping wrestlers lie.
Michaels making his way back in.
And there you go. I can't believe that. To the outside.
Crush. Unbelievable.
Crush hammering away. Got right back to his feet. Wait a minute. The bell is rung. Both men apparently counted out.
No, I think he's disqualified. Crush, hopefully.
Oh, no, I hope not. Crush back in the ring. Michaels begging up. Crush still wants to have a go. Off the rope and...
Oh, my! What a maneuver! Stop him, it's already over.
He had him go to roll like a propeller.
It's not over as far as Crush is concerned.
Get out of there, Shawn.
Shawn Michaels has had a bad week, and it looks like it's going to get worse. Oh, yes. Michaels in that vice-like grip of the original Hawaiian punch. Crush is letting him have it. Yes.
Disqualified Crush, hopefully, right?
I'm not certain. That would be a crime if, in fact, Crush was disqualified.
He's telling him, I think, you're finished.
Well, wait a minute, let's pick up the announcement.
Decision. Both men have been counted out.
Oh, wait a minute. Neither individual will go to the King of the Ring tournament. We'll be back with Mean Gene.
Okay, Jack Tunney, the King of the Ring is one thing. But there's a problem you're going to have to deal with after Dayton, Ohio, brother. What are you going to do with Yokozuna's big, nasty, stinky, wart-infested carcass after I press him over my head and slam him through the mat? Well, you know, Jimmy and myself, we put our brains together, and we came up with a real good idea. Don't call the city sanitation department, brother. Don't go out and rent one of those double-wide U-Hauls. Just let Hulk Hogan straddle his FXR, the bad to the bone bike, brother. And as I tie the noose around Yokozuna's neck, I'm gonna drag him two or three times around the block in Dayton, Ohio, down the one-way streets. I'm gonna show everybody in Tokyo, Japan, if there's any question in their mind. I'm gonna show everybody in the hierarchy, in the Eiffel Tower, in the WWF, if there's any question in their mind. And if there are any people who are not Hulkamaniacs, any so-called non-believers, I'm going to prove right in Dayton, Ohio, that Hulkamania is going to live forever. The power in the Hulkster is felt through his little teeny Hulkamaniacs. The credo of training, saying your prayers, eating your vitamins, believing in yourself, and believing in me, Hulk Hogan, is immortal. It'll live forever. Long after I'm dead and gone, there'll be a little Hulkamaniac that'll have the WWF title. But for now, it's your time, Yokozuna, to feel the strongest power on the face of the earth, the power of the pythons, the power of Hulkamania. And what you gonna do when the Hulkster and all my maniacs run wild on you, Banzai?
You know, I can feel my confidence building, and it's a great feeling knowing that I'm the number one seed in the King of the Ring tournament. And I look forward to facing Razor Ramon in the first round, because I'm going to prove to everybody that I'm not a beaten man, that I'm going to go straight back up to the top, and I'm going to be the King of the Ring, because I'm the best there is, the best there was, and the best there ever will be. I feel stronger, bigger, better, and just a little bit meaner.
Mr. Perfect, it seems to me that you like to run from me for some strange reason, but this Monday night at Raw, for the qualifying match for the King of the Ring, there must be a winner.
Check it out. I'm Johnny Polo, and get ready for an explosion.
This. It seems as though this capacity crowd is very much impressed with the presence of Adam Baum.
Oh my! He's coming in with an explosion, no doubt.
First, Centeno.
Centeno, the lock up with Adam Baum.
Seen him come and seen him go, though. I want to see if he can stick in the WWF.
Yeah, 292 pounder. Big monster. Managed by Johnny Polo. I must say I'm very much looking forward to seeing exactly what this Adam Bomb can do. He has come from out of nowhere. Adam Bomb with Centeno. Centeno seems to be in awe of Adam Bomb.
First impressions are lasting impressions, like you say. He's doing a good thing at the beginning.
Centeno yet to mount any sort of an offensive at all. To the buckle he goes. Out and, oh, look at this maneuver. Very impressive side suplex of sorts. And by the way, King, surely you were impressed earlier on with the smoking guns. Your impression thus far with this man making his debut.
I like the Adam Bomb. He comes straight from Three Mile Island, home of the nuclear meltdowns, and
dropkick. Look at that
little meltdown of his own right there.
Quite a bit of dialogue going on with Johnny Polo and Adam Bomb. I wonder whether or not you think that's his real name, King?
Of course that's his real name. Adam. A-D-A-M. Adam.
I mean, Bomb. I mean,
no, of course. Adam's his real name. Like, you know, everybody here has a real name, like Gorilla Monsoon. That's what he was. That's what his parents named him when he was born. They took one look at him, said, what can we name? Gorilla, of course.
Oh, my.
This is Adam Bomb.
Adam Bomb making his debut in the WWF. Are you impressed, Macho Man?
Very impressed, but I was also impressed with Razor Ramon and Shawn Michaels when they messed up on Monday Night Raw. You
know? Anything can happen.
Exactly.
So I guess you guys think this guy, laying face down right there, has a chance to beat Adam Bomb, huh?
Well, what about Razor Ramon? He lost to a guy that was doing pretty not so good, and all of a sudden he's on top of the wrestling world.
Adam Bomb making his debut, and we've seen him come and we've seen him go.
But hang when it gets tough.
Whoa! Oh,
that was amazing.
The Bomb was amazing.
Yeah. Yeah.
A big guy that can move, but we got a lot of them around here in the WWF.
You ready for the Bomb?
Ready for the Bomb?
Have you seen the Bomb yet? Huh? Macho Man, have you seen the Bomb yet?
Well, that was a very impressive over-the-top rope maneuver we saw just a moment ago. Adam Bomb, Johnny Polo, and...
Oh!
That Bomb was dropped. And the three count.
I'll go on record, I'm very, very, very impressed.
Here is your winner.
Adam Bomb victorious. I'll tell you what I'm impressed with. I'm impressed with the meeting the Macho Man had at a recent public school. I'm impressed with the conversation that you had, Macho Man, with a fourth grader by the name of Jasmine McNeil.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, Jerry the King.
In the entire history of the World Wrestling Federation, because it is going to be hosted by yours truly, the King of Wrestling, and it is going to be such a big
that guy's got it right.
Interview segment. It is going to be such a
his parents make him carry that segment
that it
I think
is only
referring to Lawler
that
here.
We started off with a man that is truly big, a man that is truly colossal, a man that is truly a giant. I'm talking about the 8 foot tall, over 400 pound giant Gonzalez.
You know, Lawler's about 6'1 or 2, so that'll give you some idea on just how big this man is.
He is accompanied by
look at that.
One of the
look at that.
He's an awesome physical specimen. There is absolutely no doubt about that.
Mr. Harvey Whippleman.
He's had his share of problems with The Undertaker. No doubt about that statement either.
Take a look at this.
People in awe of this guy.
Now, Mr. Whippleman, I want to welcome you and Giant Gonzalez to the King's Court. Is this lovely or not?
Oh, it's wonderful, and I'm very honored and appreciative to be standing here as the initial guest on the King's Court. Thank you for having us. The Giant Gonzalez feels the same way.
Now, let me just say that this man is not to be taken lightly. This man is like dynamite. Comes in small packages. And this man has a memory second to none. You go around reminding elephants of things they forgot, don't you? And in the back of your memory are some events that took place concerning the Undertaker.
Don't get the giant upset.
The Undertaker, very, very popular.
First of all,
obviously,
Mr. Whippleman, let me apologize for these imbecilic idiots out here who don't know how to treat somebody with the proper respect that they deserve.
Tell them, King.
But as I was saying, when you managed Kamala and you were taking him to the heights of the World Wrestling Federation, along comes The Undertaker. And when he put Kamala in that box of his, it did something to that little pea brain of Kamala's. It made him where he was never the same, and it cost you millions of dollars. And you vowed revenge. And this, I think, is your revenge. Is that right?
Exactly, Kingfish. It's just like this. I told The Undertaker, when he destroyed Kamala, that I had a big surprise for him. And you know what? When the Royal Rumble came down, I showed everybody that I was not lying. I had a truly big surprise, a giant surprise, an 8 foot tall, 443 pound, superhuman surprise. And we eliminated The Undertaker. Right now, he's got 1 foot in the grave and 1 foot on a banana peel. And pretty soon, he's gonna be a slipping, Kingfish.
Oh, I love it, Mr. Whippleman. And now, I think that the giant Gonzalez has one thing to say to you, Undertaker. Tell it.
Undertaker, I own you.
That's right. King of the Ring is just 3 weeks away. I'll be wrestling Jim Duggan in the first round on my way to becoming the King of the Ring. And nothing's gonna stop me. And there's a couple rules here. You not only have to win once, you not only have to win twice, but you have to win three times. You lose and you're out. Duggan, I'm in, you're out. Bam Bam Bigelow, the Beast from the East, is gonna be King of the Ring.
Oh, hey, Bam Bam, you got a lot of it right. It is 3 weeks away, and you got to win more than one time. But there's no way a tattooed bald man is going to beat Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Sure, you want to be the King of the Ring? I guarantee you, when you get in the ring with Hacksaw Jim Duggan, I'm going to crown you. You're blowing a lot of smoke. But when I get in the ring, it's going to be nothing but fire coming at you. Tough guy.
All right, thanks very much, Mean Gene Oakland. Indeed, this will be a qualifying matchup for the King of the Ring tournament. And I can't wait to see that eight-man tag team event on June 13th. And Brain, here comes Kamala with that slick.
He's throwing to the wolves is what he's doing.
Well, he's big enough to be on his own, but is he big enough to take care of Mr. Hughes? That matchup is next. See here, Big Kamala will go one-on-one, and his opponent making his way to the ring.
His way toward the ring, weighing 300.
Very impressed
pounds.
By the athletic ability of Mr. Hughes, and you got to say that that little jerk, whatever his name is, Whippleman, really pulled off a coup when he signed this big man.
Little jerk? Is that with a capital J so I can write this down and get it down right so I can relay it to the little jerk?
I think most
so he can tell his eight-foot friend, that big jerk, to take your head off? You want me to do that?
I didn't say that the giant Gonzalez was a jerk.
It's you just said his, he was a jerk?
His manager is rather undesirable, and I think most people would agree with that.
You know, Mr. Whippleman here used to manage Kamala. This is going to be very interesting. And he outbid all the other managers in the World Wrestling Federation.
And Mr. Hughes from behind, not wasting any time.
Big sledgehammer blows. You know, out on the spine of Kamala, follows it with a right hand, Brain.
You know why he wears those glasses?
No, really, I think it's a bad move, but why?
Because he can.
Yeah, that's true.
You don't want him on, you take him off. You say, Mr. Hughes, take those glasses off.
Irish whip far side, that's good not luck. My job. As Kamala avoided the contact.
Let's see how Kamala does without Whippleman. Let's see how he does without Kimchi. Let's see how he does without Slick.
Hughes rakes the eye, slows down the big man from Uganda. Comes right back with another right hand. Kamala a little dazed there as Hughes buries that foot right to the ribs and then to the head and out chokes him right on the ropes. Referee having problems maintaining the control in this matchup.
It's kind of like he was on his knees, like he was crawling, looking for Slick. He's lost without Slick, I believe.
He may be somewhat disoriented, but he's got to be on his own sometime.
You know, if you have a dog, do you have any pets?
Of course I have a dog.
Well, anybody who owns a dog to me is a stupid person. They like animals because they can control. They don't like to deal with humans because they can't match wits with them. But Kamala's like a dog. You walk a dog around long enough and it hangs out with you, it becomes dependent on you for food, for shelter.
Ooh, good
but without Slick or without help, he's lost. That's going to make him dangerous. Look at those drop kicks. And what is Hughes going at, 375, 360?
You got to think he's in that ballpark. Great agility for a big, huge man. And so many of the managers here in the World Wrestling Federation were recruiting this man just like football coaches around the country when he came out of high school.
And this is a qualifying match. The winner of this match is in the King of the Ring, correct?
You're exactly right.
Of course I'm exactly right. In the Brain.
Kamala.
Tell me what.
Full extension of the leg and that martial arts kick. The big splash. But again, he's showing signs of being a little bit disoriented.
He's looking for Slick. Looking.
Wait a minute.
Wait a minute.
That's Kim Chi.
They don't get along. Look at Kamala.
Kamala has just forgotten about Mr. Hughes. Kamala wants to get his hands on Kim Chi here. And Kamala catches Kim Chi with those chops, but the referee's counting. Kamala has forgotten about Mr. Hughes. He just splashed Kim Chi. And I think that Hughes is going to win it here.
Kamala's been counted out of the ring. See, he needs Slick at his side. He needs some help.
Here is your winner as a result of the countout, Mr.
That's exactly what's
Hughes.
Happened. So Mr. Hughes will advance.
And he had Hughes ready. It looked like if he just would have turned him over, he could have pinned him.
Kamala headbutt. Outside goes Hughes. But Kamala has been eliminated. Here he brings in Whippleman. And Whippleman's got he's got a wreck for his life here.
Wreck for your life.
Something, Hulkamaniacs. It's great to be back here in New York City on Monday Night Raw, where Hulk Hogan rules, 5 times WWF champion. You know, the Maniacs are gaining momentum. They're running wilder than they've ever ran because I saw them posing in line outside the studios. I saw them getting ready for Monday Night Raw, and there's a good reason for it. Hulkamania is more powerful, bigger than it's ever been, with the 5 demandments of the training, the prayers, the vitamins, believing in yourself, and believing in Hulk Hogan. We are definitely going to live forever. But you know something, Jimmy Hart? Monday Night Raw has a special meaning for you and me, brother.
You better believe it, Hulkster, because you see, this is where it all took place. Jimmy Hart, I became a Hulkamaniac right here on Monday Night Raw. Now I'm wearing the red, I'm wearing the yellow, I'm saying my prayers, I'm taking my vitamins, baby. I'm a Hulkamaniac, Daddy.
Well, you know, we all know that the pythons are the largest arms in the world, but the only thing that's as large as Hulk Hogan's pythons, brother, is Jimmy Hart's heart, brother. That's because he knows what the mania means. That's because he knows what the King of the Ring in the main event. Hulk Hogan against Yokozuna. Everybody knows what that means. That means life itself to me and my Hulkamaniacs. You know, I'm tired of going around the country and having the non-believers say, well, was it your lucky day, Hulk Hogan? Maybe it was just a fluke. How come he didn't slam the big man? Well, you know, we're getting it all together for Dayton, Ohio. And with the momentum that I feel right here on Monday Night Raw, with a pump on the pythons, larger than they've ever been, with the shape of the triceps, the deltoids, the pectoral muscles.
You know something, Jimmy Hart? Once I sense that big fat wad of sushi up, once I point him in the north, south, east, west direction and show off the power of Hulkamania, I'll slam him through the mat, brother. And just like everything else that I've said, it's been written and it's been done. So Monday Night Raw, Vince McMahon and Macho Man, friend of a kind, listen to me well. He's going down, but this time he's going down for the last time. Whether it's a natural disaster, whether the deck stacked in my favor, it doesn't matter, because the Hulkster lives, the Hulkster breathes, and when you live by the five commandments of Hulk Hogan, what you gonna do when the Hulkster, five-time champion, destroys you? Sayonara.
We're back with our Monday Night Raw. Four
pounds to the ounce, that's what we're about.
She's pretty, I like it.
I smell bacon cooking.
I smell money.
Money, money, money.
We'll put your eyes on her eyes.
Money. Ted DiBiase, Irvin R. Scheisse, the reigning tag team champions. They will, by the way, be headed to the King of the Ring event in approximately 3 weeks. They will be participating in a special eight-man tag team matchup that we will speak of in just a bit. But wait a minute. I think Ted DiBiase has something to say.
I've said it a million times in the past. Everybody's got a price for the million-dollar man.
That's right.
But especially all you New Yorkers, you're always got your hand out looking for a quick buck. Well, right here tonight, I'm going to illustrate my point one more time. I got $100.
Wait a minute.
Irwin, I think you and I need a shoe shine.
Hold my headset.
Sit down, Bobby.
It's $100. I can make $100 just like that.
Who wants to make $100?
Me.
Now, wait a minute.
Teddy.
I must say that we've seen Ted DiBiase and Irwin R. Scheisse with this before.
Come on down.
Yeah, but look, McMahon.
I think they're looking for a sucker is what they're looking
but
for.
But all the suckers got their hands up. Everybody wants to pick up $100.
Don't do it. It's not worth it.
Yeah, it is.
Come on.
It's only $25 a shoe.
Right there. Trying to humiliate everybody. Don't do it. Let's not have them get it. No.
Let him in here.
Again, this is an attempt on the part of Ted DiBiase to humiliate someone.
He can't get nobody. Nobody's going to do it.
DiBiase and Irwin R. Scheisse just want to show that their money can buy anything.
Really
they spread their money around. They think money is king. They think money is God.
But let's not prove it to him, even if it was. Who cares?
Now that little girl's going to shine their shoes.
That's a young man, I believe.
Hit my partner's
boots
real good.
Oh, man, he's doing it. I'm turning my back around. I can't watch.
Yeah, heavy on the toe, kid.
That's right.
Well, all I can say is that this young man is indeed being humiliated. He's earning his $100 here on Monday Night Raw.
Yeah, take it and burn it.
Quickest $100 you'll ever pick up.
We've got double dunks. We have a young man making $100.
$1 million man. There's $100.
Wait a minute, Ted. Wait a minute. Don't forget, kid, this is earned income. Don't forget about IRS. This is your first lesson.
That's right.
Here's your $30.
$30? The deal was $100.
Yeah, but Ted,
that young man's been ripped off. He's been ripped off. He's been humiliated.
What would he do with $30
anyway? He's been ripped off by Money Incorporated.
My guest this week is nothing short of sensational. Ladies and gentlemen, sensational Sherry.
Oh, take a look at this. What do you think, King?
Let me take a look at my calendar and see if this is Halloween or not.
It is nice to have you here.
What a magnificent dress.
What's not nice is the matter at hand, and of course we're talking about Luna Vachon. Let's digress for just a moment and talk about how this entire thing started to take place. WrestleMania 9, showing up in the corner of Shawn Michaels.
Where she didn't belong.
The incident there at the first aid area. And Monday Night Raw, a cat fight to end all cat fights. Just when is this going to come to a head?
Well, let me tell you something, Bonnie. Luna Vachon, I know that you will hear my voice. You bank your butt on one thing, little girl. No matter what it takes, I will take the hair that is within your head, which compensates for the lack of brain that you have. I will take every eyebrow from your face and anywhere else I can find it and take it out one by one.
That's gonna hurt.
And when the lights are cleared, and you know what you're gonna say to me? You're gonna say, Sherry, you truly are sensational!
You know, $2,500 is a lot of money to get back in the ring with you, Mr. Ramon. But the thing is I know that you're one upset guy, and you're not out to wrestle me this time. You're not out to just beat me. You're out to destroy me, cripple me, maim me, and I just can't do it. I got a family to support, and this is the happiest day of my life. This is the greatest thing I've ever done in my life. I come back to the dressing room after beating you. I just can't even believe I did it to begin with. I get back there, everyone's so happy, everyone's so surprised, and it's just incredible. And I don't want to ruin the fact that I actually beat someone on Monday Night Raw. It's the greatest feeling of my life. But I just can't accept $2,500 to get back in the ring with you. It's just not worth it. It's just not worth it.
Oh, Mr. Perfect, you're flying high now that you qualified last Monday night at Raw for the King of the Ring tournament. Well, Bubba, you just jumped right out of the frying pan into the fire.
That's right. Mr. Perfect, you are going down because I am the man.
So get ready, Mr. Perfect. You won't be the king of nothing after you step in the ring with Mr. Hughes. You won't be perfect anymore either, Big Daddy. Goodbye.
You know, Tatanka, it's a rarity in life that your fate can be determined ahead of time. But in this case, it's an inevitability because your undefeated string is about to come to a grinding halt in just 2 weeks. Sorry.
Narcissist Lex Luger, something that was bestowed upon me by the Great Spirit and all my people was how to realize reality. And Lex Luger, in 2 weeks, you will realize your reality and you will be sorry.
Face. Eat your heart out, Christy Brinkley. And look at this body. Eat your
You all can keep your stinking rotten mouth shut. So that you can listen to me, the true dominant female voice of the World Wrestling Federation. Sensational one. When I am through with you, you will not be referred to as sensational anymore. The girls won't call you sensational anymore. The men won't call you sensational anymore. In fact, no one will call you.
Sean, the difference between sensational Sherry and garbage?
Well, what's that, King?
Well, garbage gets picked up once in a while.
Okay, Hulk Hogan, you are the new WWF Heavyweight Champion. That's right, you stole! That's right, you're a thief! You stole it for my Yokozuna. But coming in the King of the Ring, you better be prepared. Because my Yokozuna is prepared for you. All people in Japan is waiting that he will bring back rain to the rising sun. And let me tell you, Hogan, you better train hard, and hard you better, boy-san, because my Yokozuna is waiting for you. Yokozuna will take back the belt. And once you are branded as a thief, you will be branded as a thief for the rest of your life, Hulk Hogan. All the little Hulkers will be crying. Hulk Hogan is a thief? Yes, you are a thief indeed you are. Yokozuna will bring back belt, and Emperor Akihito in Japan will be very, very happy. For all people in Japan, will be proud of our Yokozuna. Banzai ne!
Banzai! You know, it's good to be back on television talking to everyone. Notice I still got my Lucky Raw t-shirt on. You know, I was sitting back watching WWF with my grandma and grandpa. And I look on the television, there's Mr. Ramon. He's offering me $5,000. I can't believe it. He's offering me $5,000 to get back in the ring with him. You know, before it was $2,500. Now it's $5,000. And it's a really hard decision to make. But I just don't think I can accept the $5,000 knowing what could happen to me and knowing the consequences. I just can't accept it.
We're back with our Monday Night Raw. What?
Can't believe it.
What is the meaning of this? You're not scheduled to be here until next week, Mr. Fuji. Mr. Fuji, how dare you come out here along with Yokozuna and wave this flag, the only flag it should be waving here in New York City on Memorial Day is the Star Stripe Forever. What are you doing? What are you up to?
What is Memorial Day, boy son?
You know very well, Memorial Day here in the United States, if you don't know, honors those who have paid the supreme price, Mr. Fuji, for their country. That's what Memorial Day is. We honor our heroes.
Well, come June 13, we will celebrate Memorial Day.
Mr. Fuji, June 13 is the date of the King of the Ring. Today is Memorial Day. June 13 is the date Yokozuna steps into the ring with Hulk Hogan. That's what June 13 is.
Your national hero, Hulk Hogan. Chotto matte ne. Yokozuna-san. Hanashi ne.
Yo. Yo, Hulkamania will die.
Hulkamania will die.
Banzai!
Banzai is right.
Mr. Fuji along with Yokozuna. Next week, Mr. Fuji and Yokozuna scheduled to be a part of the King's Court with the King, Jerry Lawler. And by the way, it wouldn't surprise me if Hulk Hogan doesn't show up here next week.
All right.
Yeah.
Look at it. Never happen, boy, son.
And what's going to happen? Come the King of the Ring anyhow.
Banzai! In your dreams.
We're looking at a new WWF Heavyweight Champion.
Need I remind you of what happened at WrestleMania?
I have short memory, boy Tom. I don't remember the past. I only think about the future.
That's it. Why do you believe Yokozuna will defeat the Hulkster? Give me one reason on Memorial Day why.
Because he's bigger, he's stronger. And Hulkamania, let's see you think of my Yokozuna.
USA! USA!
I can't hear you, Sammy.